your kids' diversity.
It's the Chris and Amy Show.
Check it out. St. Louis, Mount City, we are going to have a great day today.
Now, Amy Marks Kors, Chris Ranji on KMOX.
Let's take it from the top.
Hey, good morning, friends. It is good to have you with us today on this Chris and Amy Show, Tuesday, March 26th.
It's a Chris and Amy Show Tuesday?
It is a Chris and Amy Show. Actually, every weekday should be a Chris and Amy Show day. You know what I mean?
I do. I know today is Tuesday, right? No basketball. But Thursday, I'm already excited for Thursday.
Oh,
how fun is Thursday going to be?
Thursday's going to be great.
We're
going
to think of
Thursday.
Something special.
I'll get back to you.
We'll think about it today, which is a regular day.
Amy Marks Kors, Chris Ranji, our number to call, 314-436-7900. We take voicemails. That's 314-944-1120. If you'd like to follow us on social media, at Chris Amy KMOX, that's Twitter and Instagram. And also, if you didn't know, obviously 1120 AM, 98.7 FM, and the free Odyssey app.
Time now for the top of the order. The top three stories everybody will be talking about.
An absolutely terrifying scene early this morning in Maryland. The Francis Scott Key Bridge collapses after a cargo ship collides with it. We will discuss that in a moment.
And today is your last day to vote in the second round of the Field of 6440 bracket of the most St. Louis-y things. The last round saw John Hamm fall to Famous Bar.
Yeah, Famous Bar won.
Will the department store continue on? It's up to you to vote. KMOX.com.
Apparently, Amy, there might be another upset brewing.
Be. Yeah. Okay. Well, KMOX.com, look on that first page, maybe scroll down a bit, you'll see our Field of 6440 bracket.
Also, as we get closer to opening day for the Cardinals, which is on Thursday in Los Angeles, Dylan Carlson leaves the game with a shoulder injury yesterday, hoping for an update today on how he is feeling. Also, Shohei Ohtani, who will be an opponent of the Cardinals, he spoke yesterday through an interpreter about the betting scandal. So, there's a lot going on with him. There's the Sean Puffy Combs, the old Diddy Combs.
Oh my gosh, I know, and that's really bad potentially.
Absolutely wild.
Granted, I don't follow Diddy Puffy.
It's Diddy right now.
Diddy, I don't follow him. I don't listen to his music. I don't know anything about him other than he kept changing his name. And this was like back when David Letterman was still a host, because David Letterman would introduce him with all of his names and made a joke about it. Okay, fine. You're talking about a sex trafficking, human trafficking scandal where you have the feds going to two of his houses.
Yeah.
They interviewed some of his neighbors. Now, granted, this is interviewing a neighbor, so it is what it is. But the guy's like, I can't believe they're raiding the house. He goes, you would see girls show up at the house, and some of them seemed young, but I guess you didn't really think anything of it. I had no idea what was going on. Really potentially abhorrent if all of those things were going on. Jeez.
We'll see if we find out anything additional about that today. But early this morning, Amy, after midnight our time, a giant cargo ship that they said was about 100,000 tons was leaving port, leaving Baltimore, Maryland, and was on its way, across the sea. And it appeared to lose power. And if you see the video, it's very dark, but you could see the lights on the ship go out once. You see some kind of smoke coming from it. Can't really tell what it is. The lights come back on. The lights go back out. And the next thing you know, it crashes into one of the bridge supports. Almost the entire bridge collapsed into the water. And it reminded me very much of, although this was contact by a cargo ship. Mm-hmm. It wasn't just a bridge that fell into the water like what happened in Minnesota several years ago. There was the accident with the Eads Bridge. You remember back in the late 90s. I have to tell you, first of all, right now, there are six people who are unaccounted for. So they are still trying to find them. The currents could have them well down the way, possibly out into the ocean. So it's a very, very scary and sad situation that is ongoing in Maryland. But Amy, I could not help but think about the amount of times I drive across a bridge. I am, maybe this is weird for me, but I feel very uneasy. Remember how you were talking about planes yesterday and how you feel uncomfortable on planes? I have a general unease when I get on a plane. I feel the same way about a bridge, even though I've done it a million times in my life.
See, and
it's
that,
so weird.
That's the thing. You've gone over bridges a million times. I feel like I have not gone over as many bridges, although the big ones now would be going into St. Charles. Yeah. I do that and I don't think anything of it. And then the Page Extension Bridge, I've done that now more recently several times. I don't think anything of that. The only time I've noticed that I'm on a bridge and where I feel, oh, this is weird. There were a couple in Florida that are maybe like a mile or a mile and a half long.
Oh, yeah. Like massive. Is it Tampa?
I'm sure it's multiple cities where you're going over the
way to the Keys, I think.
Yes.
Too.
Yeah. And it wasn't that. I've never been to the Keys, but just in Florida, those are the only times where I thought, this is a really long bridge. I would love for this bridge to be over. And I feel that unease with tunnels because they're like the Eisenhower Tunnel in Colorado. When you're in a tunnel for a really long time, it starts to weird me out.
How about the underwater tunnels?
That's why
I don't know those either.
Yeah.
There was a, if you remember, oh gosh, was it 1990? I want to say it was either 1989 or 1990. There was that guy who I think he turned out to be a bit of a kook, Dr. Ibn Browning. Do you remember this fella?
Mm-mm. I mean, unless I don't remember his name.
This was the guy who was all over TV telling people that the big earthquake was coming and that we needed to be prepared in St. Louis, and even said he had a date it was going to happen. I don't remember the exact date. But people were kind of terrified because here's this person who's allegedly an expert and is telling people this. I have scientific evidence. This earthquake is going to happen. And it wasn't too long after the San Francisco earthquake. And you recall the double-decker bridge that there was maybe a couple of miles stretch of that bridge that collapsed on top of the bridge below it and sandwiched all those cars in it. I have, from all of that, I have this fear about crossing bridges.
Interesting.
It's not a deep fear, but it's just one of those, I think about it.
But you even think about that
every time
when you go to Illinois?
Cross. Yeah.
I mean, you go to Illinois all the time. You're from Granite City.
Yeah. And I was talking to Andrew about this in the office. I don't know if anybody here has ever taken the McKinley Bridge.
Okay.
That bridge.
Is that the one you take like 270? Into Grafton or Afton?
No, it's 70.
Okay.
It's just north of downtown. It's 70. Yeah, okay. I can't think of the, I just know how to get there. It's one of those, I don't know the road names, but there's a bunch of industrial areas right there.
Yeah, I know exactly.
This bridge is very, very old. It was closed for a long time. That bridge is terrifying because it's so narrow. And there was at one point, there were two lanes going each direction.
Yeah.
Anybody who has seen the McKinley Bridge, on the outer part, there are two lanes on each side. And it looks like people can walk across it. That used to be a lane you could drive on.
Right.
It's like 3 feet wide. And I don't know how they let cars drive across that. But it is so unnerving to walk across that bridge and drive across that bridge. I don't know how people do it.
How would you have felt? Now, obviously, this bridge closed to traffic, I think, long before you were born. But would you have been able to drive on the narrow and bendy Chain of Rocks bridge? Would that have thrown you off being on a narrow bridge that curves?
The one that's right next to 270?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just
that's
north.
That's now a walkway, is it not?
I
think you can walk across.
Oh, there's a race. There's a 5K. Mark Spiewak, he's like the king of running and coaching in St. Louis. He started a race on the Chain of Rocks Bridge. Maybe it's a 6K. At any rate.
Okay.
So now, I mean, it is a walking path, but it's, yeah, you think, okay, the cars used to drive on this very narrow bridge and it turns, and how they had started making the bridge on each side and realized it didn't line up.
I do feel like when I was really little, I was probably across it. I feel like I have some vague memory of it.
That bridge
is terrible. We have some good bridges here, but we have a couple that are not.
What about Chicago? Are those little bridges too little so you don't care?
Too little. It's not really.
Yeah.
The rivers aren't.
Have you ever gone on the Golden Gate Bridge?
I have not.
I don't think
that I would like that one.
What about, I have driven across and run across like the Brooklyn Bridge. And in fact, the New York City Marathon starts on the bridges and it's on the double-decker bridge. So you have people on the top level and people on the bottom level.
Yeah, I don't like that.
Because people pee off the top level. So if you are on the bottom level, you want to stay in the middle of the bridge so you don't get hit.
They do?
Yeah, because it's before a race.
Ow.
Yeah, kind of gross. But
runners are really disgusting people.
They are. We are.
Doing all kinds of weird stuff in public.
Yeah, but going back, I mean, this is a huge deal with Baltimore. I know they're changing the traffic, obviously, because certain parts of Baltimore now the roadways are closed, especially with hazardous materials. You're not supposed to truck and drive
right
through certain areas. And it's really shaken up, obviously, everyone who sees the images. But if you grew up in that area, you're so familiar with that bridge. And to see the ship, the barge, hit one of the pillars, but then the domino effect across the entire Potomac River is really stunning. And in my head, I talked to someone this morning who's like an engineer. I thought, is it supposed to, in my head, not all of the other pillars would crumble, right? Imagine you hit a pillar and a large portion of the bridge falls.
Let me guess. Did he say something along the lines of that ship is so big and so heavy that it doesn't matter?
Because
it was like 100,000 tons.
Right.
Or something.
And it also, he's like, it depends on how the bridge was constructed. He's like, you know, there's so many different types of ways.
Right.
But in my head, I don't know why. Yes, I would think that a huge portion of that bridge would fall, but the way it collapsed around all the other pillars is really stunning to see. And I know they were using sonar, I guess you would call it, or some sort of search device. And they found five vehicles, three cars, a dump truck, and another car that they found at the bottom of the Potomac, and they're still looking for six people.
There were construction workers on the bridge doing some concrete work, I believe.
And thank goodness it was 1:30 in the morning.
The belief is that they are the ones who are missing right now. Mm. So it's devastating. And one of the things that I can't help but think about is, and who knows, maybe there's nothing they could have done to that bridge to make it sturdy enough to withstand being hit by that particular ship, because the ship was gigantic and it was full. It was a container ship. It was full of stuff. So maybe there's no way to have constructed it in such a way that it could withstand that.
It's not an old bridge. It's your age, 1977.
That's kind of old.
It's not that old. It's not like the Eads Bridge.
No, it's not. But here's the point. I don't know if it's preventable. If the ship loses power and there's nothing the pilot can do about it, and that's apparently what happened here. So I don't blame him until we get more details and maybe we find out that he did do something wrong. But at this point, it does look like there was some sort of malfunction, which would not be his fault. But we have to be mindful about when we build things, cutting corners. And I think that there are way too many times, not just in this country, it happens everywhere, but this is why we have regulations. This is why we make sure companies, whether they're private or public or whatever they are, don't cut corners when they are building things, whether it's office buildings, bridges, infrastructure of any kind. Never cut corners. And I think too many entities do that just so they can save money.
Yeah, and I would argue they do it less here than they do in a lot of other countries, partly because of regulations. You see the devastation of earthquakes or flooding, smog that happens in Peru. Such a beautiful country. But my friend who's from there, he went home, visited his family, said he couldn't even run because he said there's no regulations with burning, with automobiles, a lot of old cars. You see older cities that kind of build and rebuild towns, like whether it was the earthquake in Nepal or in Turkey or Morocco, just they're old. And there's one thing to be said for old if it's historic, but then also that there's no regulation when you rebuild or repair.
Yeah.
It sets up to make a catastrophic event even more deadly.
We do it a lot better than a lot of other countries, but it doesn't mean we do it well enough, because we can do it better. And I think we should do it better. That's Amy Marks Kors. I'm Chris Ranji. You're welcome to visit with us. 314-436-7900. It's the Chris and Amy Show on KMOX.
Two ways to listen to KMOX in your car. 98.7 in the city, 1120 a.m. further out. The voice of St. Louis, KMOX.
Just imagine being walked all over for 36 years. Who would do that? The great customers of Reinhold Flooring, that's who. For over 3.5 decades, Reinhold Flooring has been the mecca for carpet, hardwood, vinyl, laminate, and area rugs. Reinhold Flooring is customer-driven with a focus on top-quality products and installations from the best team in the business. So come on in and walk all over your next flooring at Reinhold Flooring. Visit them at 5429 Telegraph Road in St. Louis or online at reinholdflooring.com.
This is Christina Strait with Strait Realty reminding you why pay more than four. In 2003, we had a dream to start a real estate company that would revolutionize the real estate market. Now, 20 years later, after navigating through the many markets' ups and downs, we know exactly how to help you in this challenging time. I'm Christina Strait, owner of Strait Realty. Don't give away your hard-earned equity. Give us a call today, 314-441-4444. 314-441-ALL-4s. And remember, why pay more than four?
Strait Realty is a licensed broker in the state of Missouri.
Let's Save Lives. An introduction to suicide prevention is an education program designed by and for the Black community. To learn more, go to afsp.org/chapters. AFSP is an I'm Listening partner. Learn more at imlistening.org and on the Odyssey app.
Progressive asks, what do a slow Friday night, bored teenage boys,
I'm bored,
a pack of fireworks,
this is gonna be awesome,
and a teetering branch suspended over your car have in common?
Look out! Run!
They can quickly wreak havoc on your slow Friday night.
Uh-oh.
Bundle your home and auto with Progressive for great savings and round-the-clock protection.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company affiliates and other insurers. Not available in all states or situations.
Find what you love. Love what you find. A Total Wine and More. There's so much waiting for you. Spirits and beer. Thousands of wines. Walk right through the door. It's all here to explore. With guides in the know and prices so low, it just might blow your mind. Mine. You're gonna find what you love and love what you find.
Drink responsibly, B21.
Are your health insurance premiums making you sick? Did you go with one of those high deductible, limited network Obamacare plans? Well, you're not stuck with it. Or did you go with a plan outside the marketplace that's costing you an arm and a leg? There are better options. Kim Kufer at H&L Agency offer plans where you only meet a deductible if you go into a hospital. You pick your doctors, and it's 30 to 60% lower than most other plans. If you pay for your own health insurance, you're uninsured, you're on COBRA, or your employer coverage is just too expensive, you need to talk to an expert. Call Kim at 800-975-2841. That's 800-975-2841. Or go to hnlagency.org. And is spelled out. That's hnlagency.org. hnlagency.org. They can customize a plan chosen and managed by you, not the government.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/joy and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
No fights, just insights. Talking politics with respect for all. This is KMOX.
Text message here says, and this is from a 314, the Francis Scott Key Bridge did not appear to have large safety islands to prevent big ships from hitting the piers. And I did hear somebody, it was an expert earlier today, say that very thing. They weren't exactly sure if there were those barriers around the pillars, but that's one of the things that you can do to prevent a ship of that size getting too close to it and potentially doing what happened today. So I don't know, but we're going to find out more about the construction of the bridge,
yeah,
whether and there were corners cut on that,
which
there are going to be a lot of lawsuits too.
Yeah. I don't know. Like, I didn't hear anything in what I've read, anything about corners cut about the bridge. I've heard more questions about the ship, which I believe is a company out of Singapore.
Yep.
And how it lost power and what was going on. We know there was a mayday sent out. We know the pilots, I think, were pretty darn experienced. So
they have to be. There is, by law, to steer in and out of a harbor, you have to have somebody there who knows the harbor. So, it can't just be the pilot from across the ocean.
So I had heard more questions about the ship rather than the bridge, and I don't know. And also, you know, I don't know why the power went out. Once the power did go out, I don't know what agency the pilots had, probably zero. What are you going to do with a giant ship like that? And then also with a bridge made to withstand a lot, maybe there was nothing you could do to make a bridge withstand the weight of that barge.
Think about that ship that got stuck in the Suez Canal, the Ever Given. It was, you know, you had an experienced pilot on that. And sometimes those currents, I forgot what the current is actually called, but it just steered that ship. And no matter how much power it had, it wasn't going to be able to get past that current and overcome it. I don't know. This is it's terrifying. I'll say that. And here's another thing that I want to make sure we do, because I've seen it a little bit, and I hope this is the kind of behavior that just gets pushed to the corner of the internet and nobody serious ever really pays attention to these folks. But the Andrew Tate types who are trying to, the people who love to tell you,
jail.
I thought so too. Those types of people who love to, they pride themselves on questioning everything and there's something they're not telling us. This was not intentional. I would be stunned.
Is he saying that?
There are a lot of people who are suggesting that this is intentional. And again, because they're, you know, that mindset, they have to be part of the conspiracy. They have to know about the conspiracy. It makes them feel better about themselves.
Well, yeah, I haven't heard that.
And it looks like the ship lost power.
Andrew Tate was in jail.
He should be. That guy's gross. Anyway, when we come back, we're going to talk Russia and the terrorist attack that happened there on Friday. Dr. Krister Knapp will join the show when we come back. It's Chris and Amy on KMOX.
I saw a werewolf with a Chinese menu in his hand, walking through the streets of Soho in the rain.
For over 22 years, the Dave Glover Show has been the unrivaled voice of St. Louis. Dave Glover, Rachel Zimmerman, and Kevin Wheeler, with a legacy of fearless commentary, no topic is off the table on this brilliantly unpredictable show. Intelligent and unapologetically outside the political norms. The Dave Glover Show, where entertainment and authenticity collide. Weekdays at 1 on Nord KMOX.
It's time for a $98 furnished tune-up.
When selling your home, you want the most money and the least hassle. That's exactly what you get when you work with trusted realtor Gloria Liu with Your Home Sold Guaranteed Realty. This is Debbie Monterey, and selling your home is one of the biggest financial decisions you will ever make, and that's why having an expert on your side is crucial. Other agents know that some sellers will choose the agent that tells them the highest price they can get for their home, and that can be a dangerous strategy. Most of the time, it ends up being empty promises. Gloria Liu doesn't make empty promises. She makes guarantees in writing. Gloria Liu will guarantee to sell your home at your agreed-to price and time frame, or she'll buy it. Guaranteed in writing. So pick up the phone and call Gloria Liu, 314-325-6888, 314-325-6888, or online at GloriaHasTheBuyers.com. Conditions apply. Gloria and seller must agree on price and possession date. Gloria Liu, your home sold guaranteed realty.
Retiring soon? Get the information you need by joining Kyle Jones and Matt Allgaier of FIRA Capital Management for your retirement highway, Sunday mornings at 9:30. Investment advisory services made available through Pine Ridge Advisors, LLC, a registered investment advisor. Securities made available through AE Financial Services, LLC, member FINRA and SIPC.
Let's talk garage doors. Your garage door. Is it too loud or letting cold or hot air in around the frame? Overhead Door Company of St. Louis will make it all better. In March only, they will perform their full 26-task garage door tune-up for just $79, and just in March. That's just $79 for up to 3 garage doors and openers. You need this done once a year, so why not now? And for just $79. Schedule now at OverheadDoorsSt.Louis.com.
At 10:30, windy and 42 degrees downtown at the Arch. More on the developing story, the cargo ship that hit Baltimore's Key Bridge, bringing it down. Rescuers still looking for people in the water. Washington correspondent Sagar Magani reports the bridge collapse will have an impact on commerce.
The Key Bridge straddles the Patapsco River at the entrance to a busy harbor and leading to the Port of Baltimore, a major East Coast shipping hub. Maryland's transportation chief says all vessel traffic in and out of the port will be suspended until further notice.
A court victory for WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange in the UK. London's High Court has ruled he cannot be extradited to the U.S. to face espionage charges unless officials here guarantee he won't get the death penalty. Assange's wife Stella spoke outside the courthouse.
The courts recognize that Julian is exposed to a flagrant denial of his freedom of expression rights.
CBS News correspondent Jim Crisula reports on a legal challenge to a ban on critical race theory in the South.
A teacher and two students at the historic Little Rock Central High School, including Sadie Bell Reynolds, have sued Arkansas over the state's ban on critical race theory classes in public schools.
I've never felt shamed in Ms. Walls's classroom about learning about another perspective. It's just what has happened in our history.
The legal challenge comes after the state said an advanced placement course on African American studies would not count toward state credit. The lawsuit seeks to have a federal judge rule the law unconstitutional. Jim Crisula, CBS News.
We've got emergency vehicles on 364 going east to Bennington Place. The left lane is closed. Some debris on 55 south at Route M. That's in the center lane. And also debris on 70 west at 141. That's got the right lane closed. We've got a water main break on 15 east at 26th. And some construction on 55 70 east at 203 in the right lane. And the forecast is sponsored by the St. Louis Work Zone Awareness 5K and 1 mile fun run. For tonight, some clearing, chilly, low 34 degrees. For tomorrow, we've got sunny conditions, warmer with a high of 55, looking for a high of 48 today. Join the St. Louis Work Zone Awareness 5K and 1 mile fun run Saturday, April 20th in Chesterfield. Sign up today at modot.org/St. Louis and buckle up, phone down so we all get home safe. Brought to you by the Missouri Coalition for Roadway Safety Fund. Right now, we've got wind and 42 downtown at the Arch. I'm Michael Calhoun, KMOX News.
Hey, it's Jim Costa from Cash the Ticket. Tourney time is here. Mike Valeni and I are going through every matchup of the Big Dance over on the podcast. We're talking sides, totals, mix in a reckless parlay every now and then. Come on, it's fun. We've got tourney trends, futures plays, who wins the national title, something for every bettor and every sports fan. Region by region, game by game, however you want to digest it, it's there. Download Cash the Ticket today. It's on the Odyssey app or wherever you get your podcasts.
I'm Dave Glover, and I see clearly now thanks to the doctor's doctors, Dr. Greg Birdie, Ranjan Malhotra, Robert Broussardi, Andy Royer, and Samuel Barry. You can too. Just go to youreyedoc.com.
Broadcasting from the Under Law Injury Lawyers, getjim.com studios.
KMOX.
Your bathroom is boring and basic too. It seems like there's nothing you can do. A better bath awaits. You'll feel brand new, relaxing in a world of peace at the Bath Authority.
Hey, it's Tom Ackerman. Right now, schedule your free in-home estimate and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Restrictions apply. A better bath awaits.
You're our priority at the Bath Authority.
Are you the decision maker in your company? Consider this. For the first time in decades, there's a better option for a corporate card and spend management platform. Meet Ramp, the only corporate card and spend management system designed to help you spend less money so you can make more. Most corporate credit cards offer points as incentives, but those points amount to less than their worth in real cash value. Ramp's corporate cards offer you cash back, real money in your pocket. Plus, you control who spends what with each vendor. And Ramp software collects and verifies receipts automatically, which means you'll stop wasteful spending and close your books in hours instead of days. Businesses that use Ramp add up to 5% to their bottom line the first year. If you're a decision maker, adding Ramp could be one of the best decisions you've ever made. And now get $250 when you join Ramp. Just go to ramp.com/free. ramp.com/free. ramp.com/free.
Cards issued by Sutton Bank and Celtic Bank, members of FDIC. Terms and conditions apply.
The Cardinals open the 2024 season Thursday against the Dodgers in L.A. John Rooney and Ricky Horton have the call. Hamlin pregame show 215. First pitch 310. Hear it here on your home of the St. Louis Cardinals. King of OX.
It is the Chris and Amy show on KMOX. Time to go to the Quiver River Electric guest line. Joining us this morning, Dr. Krister Knapp, professor and coordinator of crisis and conflict and historical perspective at Washington University. And with us this morning, good morning, Dr. Knapp. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you, Chris?
We are doing okay. So we are have been paying attention to what happened in Moscow just at the end of last week. The terrorist attack, over 100 people were killed in that attack. There's all sorts of confusion. And from our perspective, it seems like the confusion is really coming from the Kremlin.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's some truth in that. It's not unusual for autocrats like Putin. In fact, it's a common playbook for them to want to create confusion around an event like this that makes the Russian state and, by implication, Putin look weak, not in control of his state, not able to protect our Russian citizens. He does project himself as a strong leader. Russians expect and have historically enjoyed and supported and wanted nothing less than a strong leader. And so that when there's a terrorist attack like this, we all know from our own experiences that they can be very, very devastating. They seem to come out of the blue. They appear to be random. They shock us. And of course, they traumatize us. Now, of course, terrorist attacks are not random. They don't come out of the blue. There's a reason why terrorist groups like ISIS-K engage in these attacks. But for Putin, this kind of attack would make him look weak. And so given that his main concern is Ukraine right now, if he could spin this in any way in a public relations way, in which, of course, he does have control over the state media, to somehow be connected to Ukraine, even though it appears, at least to all evidence so far, that it is not, then this can only sort of help him regain his stature as a strong leader.
I feel like we often have a tendency to project an American understanding on global events. So we see Russia, we think Ukraine, we look at Israel and Gaza, and then this ISIS attack may seem to the casual American observer as random. But when you look at global jihad and then the prongs that ISIS does have in many countries, including Russia, this is not as surprising or random as it may seem to us here.
You know, Amy, I think that's an excellent insight. It's a really good observation. And I think it gives us reason to pause and reflect on why a group like ISIS-K would engage in attack of this nature at this time. And so it's maybe just worth reminding ourselves that these groups do have their own origins, their own ideology, their own historical trajectory, and their own, you know, reasons for being on why they do what they do. And so, you know, in the case of ISIS, it's important to understand that this is a very unique group that is actually a little different than Al-Qaeda, even though it has some of its historical roots in Al-Qaeda. Much more so than Al-Qaeda, ISIS is a prophetic Islamist group. It really believes in the prophecies in the Quran, and it believes fervently in what we call the end of times, that the end of times on this this world is coming, and that ISIS's sole purpose is to bring about the apocalypse. And the apocalypse will occur when the Mahdi returns. And the Mahdi is the Islamic version of God's or Allah's messenger. And he will gather up all the rightly believing Muslims who exist in one place for the afterlife. But first, ISIS has to create the right conditions for the Mahdi to return and for the apocalypse to occur. And so these have involved creating a caliphate or a religious state that is based on strict interpretation and strict implementation of Sharia law or religious law as understood by a very strict and fundamentalist version of Sunni Islam known as the Salafists. And ISIS believes that they have to either convert all non-believers, that includes all Shia Muslims or non-Salafist Sunnis, and of course all non-Muslims to Salafism. And those that won't convert, everyone else has to be killed. This is a very extreme apocalyptic group. And so when it looks out at the world, it sees certain states, certain powers, and certain groups as standing in the way of being able to create a caliphate. Those are Europe in former Muslim lands in southeastern Europe. Those are the United States in the Middle East. Those are the Jews in the Middle East. And those are Russia in Central Asian provinces where there are very large Muslim populations. And so when ISIS-K, which is the latest descendant of the original ISIS group, although existing and operating out of Afghanistan, it has cells in Russia. It has cells in the Central Asian states. And it looks at Russia's past behavior, the Soviet jihad in Afghanistan in the 1970s and 80s, Russia's behavior in Syria in the 2010s when it helped keep Assad in power and kept the Salafists down there, Russia's behavior in Chechnya in the 1990s and the 2000s where it oppressed Muslims. I mean, there's just like ongoing support of by Russia or formerly Soviet power that keeps Muslims down. And so in the eyes of ISIS-K, Russia is a legitimate target. And so in the last, since 2016, there have been six separate attacks in Russia. And this is only the latest. So when you look at this attack, Amy, you're exactly right. We shouldn't project an American interpretation on it. We should understand that ISIS and ISIS-K in particular has had a long-term goal to bring down Moscow.
So is there similar leadership or is there some overlap here between ISIS-K and the ISIS that we know?
No, so the original ISIS leadership is gone due to a coalition forces led by the United States, right? So the original caliphate existed from 2014 under al-Baghdadi and lasted until 2019 after on a punishing air campaign with U.S. proxy forces on the ground under the Obama and Trump administrations. And al-Baghdadi himself eventually blew himself up when he was cornered a few years later by special forces in Syria. And there have been a series of subsequent leaders of the overall umbrella group, or what you might call the ISIS core group. But after the caliphate was disbanded, part of what al-Baghdadi said was that the perpetrators who helped bring about the end of the caliphate had to be punished. And those were the U.S. and Russia and Europe and, of course, Jews and Israel. So the usual line of suspects for ISIS leadership. But what happened was that just like al-Qaeda, after it was dispersed from Pakistan and Afghanistan when we went in, they created a bunch of cells and franchises across the globe in Muslim countries, in Africa, in the Middle East, in Southeast Asia, and in Central Asia, where ISIS is particularly strong. So they have decentralized leadership. But ISIS-K is probably the strongest or one of the strongest of all of the affiliated groups. And it has decided, after trying to attack the Taliban in Afghanistan, which they see as non-believers or at least not rightly believing Muslims, but the Taliban have actually done a pretty good job of keeping them down there. So I think ISIS-K has decided that it will go after what it would call a far enemy strategy, which is why it has returned to attacking Russia. And I should add that there have been numerous plots against European targets, including the Roman Cathedral, the Catholic Cathedral in Cologne in Germany, that have been disrupted. So ISIS-K is very active outside of Afghanistan in its far enemy strategy.
This, you may have said this already, so I apologize if it's a dumb question. Does the K refer to the Khorasan province?
No, excellent question. It does refer to the Khorasan province, which harkens back to the 9th century period of the Umayyad dynasty, in which Khorasan is sort of this geographical zone that crosses what we would call the Persian or nowadays Iranian steppe, which stretches from current day Iran all the way through Central Asia and occupies most of the Central Asian states. So whether it's al-Qaeda or ISIS or any of these other fundamentalist militant Islamist groups that use terrorism as a tactic to try to attack the enemy and bring about the caliphate, they have different ideas about where this caliphate should exist. Should it exist in the traditional lands of Islam in the Arabian Peninsula? Should it exist in the Iranian steppe, which is, you know, the sort of classic area that going all back to Alexander the Great and the many dynasties that occupy that region of Central Asia, or somewhere else? But whatever it is, Khorasan refers to this region in which they want to set up this religious state.
Lastly, Putin did, as we talked about earlier, he sort of put the blame on Ukraine for this attack because it benefits him personally. Would it even be would it even make sense for this group to escape back into Ukraine or for Ukraine to even aid them in any way?
Not that I can see. I mean, Ukraine is being backed by the United States. And I can't see why ISIS-K would feel that or its members would think that Ukraine would act as a safe haven in any way for these groups. I mean, there seems to be no sort of rational reason for that. In fact, if anything, the Ukrainians would have picked them up and turned them over to either the Russian or the American or some other Western authorities, you know. So there's no reason to believe that they would find refuge in Ukraine. And I think the idea that Ukraine would be acting, you know, together or in concert with ISIS-K, again, is more of a product of the way in which Putin wants to spin it, or other conspiracy theorists might be thinking about it, but doesn't really bear much resemblance to the facts and evidence that we, at least as we know it, regarding this group.
Dr. Knapp, as always, we appreciate the information. Thank you for talking with us today.
Thanks for having me on. Always a pleasure.
Dr. Christer Knapp, professor and coordinator of crisis and conflict and historical perspective at Washington University. It is the Chris and Amy Show on KMOX.
KMOX Kegs and Eggs, presented by Budweiser, returns to 7th Street in downtown St. Louis before the home opener Thursday, April 4th. Tickets are sold out, but through March 31st, you have a chance to win a pair of tickets. Submit your email address on the Kegs and Eggs contest page and click Submit. Come celebrate this unofficial holiday with Dirt Cheap, Aloha Pools USA, Rally House and Victory Men's Health, a men's health clinic dedicated to health optimization. Details at KMOX.com/contest.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential. But finding those people can be a major hassle, unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now you can try it for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Warmer spring weather is right around the corner, and now is the time to plan your home's exterior renovation project. Banner Construction is booking now for homeowners to be first in line for beautiful James Hardy siding and Pella replacement windows. Beat the price increases and plan your project now. Visit BannerConstruction.com or call 314-569-1050 and get a free in-home design and estimate. 314-569-1050 and have a banner day.
Genesis of St. Charles wants you in a new Genesis. Just for owning a Nissan, Hyundai, or a Highline vehicle, you could get up to $2,000 in incentives on a GV70 or a GV80. You don't even have to trade that vehicle in. If you're military or first responder, they can add on to that incentive. So check out genesisofstcharles.com for a full listing of qualifying vehicles. Genesis of St. Charles, just days away from opening their brand new showroom. There are so many ways to get behind the vehicle of your dreams at genesisofstcharles.com.
To the 20, to the 10, to the 5, to the house.
Faro Field, home sweet home for Tiger Nation on 7 Saturdays each fall. The traditions and tailgating run deep. The victories roar louder. And you can't get energy like this sitting on your couch. So don't wait. Get up and get in the game. Lock in your seats today because every seat is front row to greatness. Call 1-800-CAP-PAUSE or visit mutigers.com/tickets. M-I-Z.
The weekend. 2 whole days for you to sit back, relax, and clean some gutters. Ah, the joy of scooping up soggy, gunky, muddy sludge. And if you're really lucky, you may find your dog's old crusty tennis ball covered in leaves. Where did they all come from anyway? You don't even own a tree. Forget the weekends. Mow Money Mondays are here. New scratchers, new chances to win. Every last Monday of the month, only from the Missouri Lottery.
Play responsibly.
What if there is a murderer walking among us? Follow the clues. Solve the mystery.
This village really is a place where murder is easy.
Agatha Christie's Murder is Easy, a brand new BritBox original series, is streaming now, adding to the largest collection of Agatha Christie, including Miss Marple, Poirot, Why Didn't They Ask Evans, and more.
The whole collection, it is magnificent.
Stream the best of British TV, only on BritBox. Start a free trial at BritBox.com.
She posted about us just now.
Celebrities can't get enough of Bianna's bespoke skincare line.
She has 147 million followers. How do we monetize?
She needs a social media associate to help her with the hype.
We should repost this. Do we need a hashtag?
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
The choice of a lawyer is an important decision and should not be based solely on advertisements.
If you've been injured in a truck accident, you need the best. Ondra Law. Let us make your case our cause. Truck accident? Call Ondra Law for a free review at 314 or 618-9000.
For all station contest rules, go to kmox.com/rules.
Don't let a cold, sinus infection, or allergies ruin your day. Breathe easier, sleep better, and feel healthier with Navage. Visit Navage.com, Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, or a store near you.
Amy Markscourt.
Fabulous.
Chris Ranji.
Unbelievable.
On KMOX.
Did you see that thing?
I can't believe it. Something is obviously wrong.
This is a joke, right?
Oh my God.
Are you freaking kidding me? No way.
You gotta be kidding me.
Don't feel bad. There's no way you could have known that.
Now, did you see this with Chris and Amy on the show?
Well, Ron, I don't know if you've ever eaten at Chick-fil-A. You've heard of
yeah,
them.
I've eaten there.
Yeah, well, and how the fillets would always say,
oh, yeah.
No antibiotics ever.
I did see
no
this.
No antibiotics ever since it, you know, that's the stance it's had since 2019. Well, now their slogan is some antibiotics sometimes.
Wow.
Because okay. I guess they're saying that it had to bend its own rule because the quantity of antibiotic-free chicken it needs for its restaurants, and that even like Tyson Foods and Panera have made similar changes. So just the price and the quantity of chicken needed, that now it is no longer no antibiotics ever. It is some antibiotics sometimes.
There just aren't enough chickens out there.
You know,
there aren't enough antibiotic-free chickens.
I probably have had so many antibiotics in those rotisserie chickens now I think about it. I need to buy them. I need to buy the all natural ones. No antibiotics, because I mean, I don't want all the chicken antibiotics.
Well, they don't want to cook you a chicken with bird flu. So you got to have the antibiotics, I guess.
You can't cook out the bird flu?
I don't know. I don't know anything about it. Amy, did you see it that the NFL is actually doing it? Remember how we talked about weeks ago, the NFL Rules Committee considering adopting the XFL/UFL's kickoff rules?
It's official?
They've done it. The owners have voted. It is happening. So in the 2024 season, the offensive and defensive teams will line up 5 yards apart, and or maybe it's 10, instead of the way it traditionally has been done, where they are running the length of the field and then making contact at full speed. So kickoffs are going to look like XFL/UFL kickoffs.
Is it also NFL related? Because I have one too.
Yes. So they are going to play a Christmas Day game this year.
Oh no, I have another NFL one.
And what's weird about it is Christmas is Wednesday, and there used to be a rule that you can't play on Wednesday because, you know, it's a short week and guys have to get ready.
Yeah,
they're doing it anyway because they say the ratings are too good.
Wow. Do you know they know who's playing?
I don't know.
Isn't it always the Detroit Lions? Why do I feel like it's always the Detroit Lions?
Lions had the Thanksgiving Day game.
Oh, maybe that's Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Wow, that's really interesting. Okay, quickly, are you happy about the new kickoff rules?
Yeah, I think it's great.
Okay. So this one, I don't understand. You explain to me how people tell me how they're going to tackle in the NFL, because the NFL is eliminating the hip drop tackle. The team owners voted unanimously. And I was watching this video. I think it was RG3, what's his name?
Robert Griffin III.
Yes, RG3. It was his account. And showing video after video of hip drop tackles, which is basically just you tackle as you're kind of falling, right? You're not running through the tackle, kind of. That's a perfectly clean tackle. Why are they getting rid of it? And how are you going to tackle if you can't hip drop tackle?
They're worried about blowing out offensive players' knees and ankles. That's what it's all about with the tackle, by putting undue force on the bottom part of the leg.
So now when you tackle, you have to stay on your feet?
It's very similar to why you can't do a horse collar. Okay. A horse collar is way more dangerous, but...
So you can be going forward or sideways as long as your hip isn't the first part of your body to go down. You have to run through it or just, like, dive through them.
Yeah, I guess.
Man.
Anyway, I'm not too upset with it.
But if you're a defensive player...
They'll figure it out.
I don't think they will. That's why Torrey Holt said he would eat if he played in today's NFL.
Yeah.
It's so catered towards the offense.
But also, that's what people pay to see. People want action. They want offense. Yeah,
not
they like
me.
The big hits.
I like low-scoring games.
Well, of course
you do. The fewer the touchdowns.
Because you are boring. That's why you like it so much.
No, yeah, anyway, okay. Well, you're fine with it. That's surprising. I just feel like it's... I don't even know how you tackle anymore.
Well, a lot of people think it's going to be bad. I think defensive players will adjust to it. They'll figure it out like they always do. There are still times where, like making contact with a quarterback, you do wonder what the defensive player is supposed to do.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times it does not look like a terrible hit and it gets called.
And one more quick headline. Trader Joe's is raising the price of its bananas for the first time in 20 years.
Okay.
So watch out.
Guess I'll never go there now.
Be careful.
Out of protest. It's the Chris and Amy Show on KMOX.
Hey, it's Bo Matthews for Reinhold Electric. You know, spring storms are definitely a-coming, right? Don't get left in the dark. Reinhold Electric is here to help. Of course, they have 24/7 emergency service, but if you're thinking about a backup generator, like an inline one that comes on when the power goes out, Reinhold Electric is absolutely who you want to call. Be prepared for the spring storms. Call Reinhold Electric today. 314-631-1158. Online at reinholdelectric.com. Wherever you hear my voice, Reinhold Electric is going to keep you electrified.
Do you have heart failure and often hear,
"Those stomach issues ruined your birthday.
You're too tired to play catch, Grandpa."
Sweetie, you haven't touched your tool since the carpal tunnel syndrome diagnosis.
If these seemingly unrelated symptoms sound familiar, talk to your cardiologist. Ask about transthyretin amyloid cardiomyopathy, or ATTR-CM, a rare and underdiagnosed disease that gets worse over time. Learn more at yourheartcomesfirst.com. That's yourheartcomesfirst.com. Sponsored by Pfizer.
Spring cleaning is upon us, but there's one meaningful box that you don't throw away when cleaning out your closet. It's the box filled with your family's important videotapes, film reels, and photos. Hi, I'm Adam Baselager.
And I'm Nick Mako. We started Legacy Box over a decade ago to help families organize and update their analog media to digital.
Legacy Box is simple and easy. It works and is safe. Over a million families have trusted Legacy Box.
And Legacy Box has been featured in Good Housekeeping, The Today Show, and Rachel Ray.
Legacy Box is like magic, converting your shoebox of memories to the cloud or thumb drive, ready to watch and share.
Declutter your closet by digitizing your media. Become more organized and accomplished, knowing your family's recorded past is safe forever. Take advantage of our spring cleaning sale going on now. It's the easiest task to check off your to-do list.
For a limited time, you can get started for just $9 a tape. Visit legacybox.com/value to get our $9 sale. That's legacybox.com/value to get our $9 offer. Legacybox.com/value.
KMOX, KEZK, HD2, K254, CR, St. Louis.
The home of the Cardinals, KMOX. Always live on the free Odyssey app.
We're going abroad for the first time in years. To Spain.
But we don't speak Spanish.
So we started using Babbel.
And started learning Spanish fast.
With Babbel, you can start having conversations in another language in just 3 weeks. Babbel's conversational method teaches you real-life words and phrases. And with Babbel's interactive bite-sized lessons, you'll remember what you learned.
¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
¿De dónde eres?
¿De dónde eres?
When you learn a language, you want to actually use it. Babbel is designed with that goal in mind.
In just 3 weeks, we're starting to have conversations in Spanish.
Estoy muy emocionado para ir a España contigo.
Aw, he just said, "I'm very excited to go to Spain with you. Nos vamos a divertir mucho."
And that means we're going to have a lot of fun.
Sí. Gracias, Babbel.
Babbel, language for life. Celebrating 10 million subscriptions sold. Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. Just go to Babbel.com and start learning a new language today. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
Mid-America's most trusted source for news.
KMOX.
At 11 o'clock, we've got windy conditions and 43 degrees downtown at the Arch. I'm Michael Calhoun, our top story this hour.
CBS News special report. The stunning collapse of Baltimore's Key Bridge could have been much worse. The ship that hit the massive span overnight, bringing it down, had sent a May Day alert that it lost power. Maryland Governor Wes Moore.
We're thankful that between the May Day and the collapse that that we had officials who were able to begin to stop the flow of traffic so more cars were not up on the bridge.
Six people remain unaccounted for, and divers have been in the waters all morning using sonar to search for them. They are believed to be construction workers who were on the bridge repairing potholes at the time. The bridge crumbled in seconds after being hit. Locals could hardly believe what they saw this morning.
Could be a long road, long time, but hopefully, you know, in the end, it'll rise again out of the depths.
The bridge had recently been rated in fair condition by inspectors. CBS News special report. I'm Cammy McCormick.
The U.S. Supreme Court heard arguments today on whether or not the FDA overlooked serious safety problems with the accessibility of mifepristone. KMOX asked Jamil Fields-Alsbrook, an assistant professor for the SLU Center of Health Law Studies, whether the plaintiffs have standing to bring the case forward.
They, you know, have a concern about abortion access as a general matter, not that they themselves have been harmed by abortion. There has been no claims that they have. So personally, I think there are some problems with them having standing.
Professor Alsbrook says there's been over 20 years of record of women using the drug, and it's been used in other countries before then. Missouri House Speaker Dean Plocker, fending off an ethics investigation into allegations of misconduct, announced today he will drop out of the lieutenant governor's race and instead seek the Republican nomination for Secretary of State. The announcement comes on the final day candidates can file to run for the August primary. It could be a once-in-a-lifetime experience for tens of millions, a total solar eclipse, Monday, April 8th. It'll cross North America. Here in the U.S., the path of totality includes 15 states from Texas to Maine. NASA is getting ready.
It's a moment when millions of people across North America will look to the heavens as the moon passes in front and between the sun and the earth. And it's a rare sight that we haven't seen in 7 years.
NASA Administrator Bill Nelson, the next total solar eclipse to be visible in the United States won't be until August 2044. The KMOX Business Desk. We told you yesterday about Boeing CEO David Calhoun planning to step down at the end of the year after a series of safety issues. CBS travel editor Peter Greenberg tells KMOX what Boeing's problems, how they're affecting the industry.
The airlines are having to readjust their schedules for the summer and the fall. They've had to readjust their pilot training. Southwest Airlines had to do a whole new schedule because they don't have the planes to support the schedule they were publishing. And United Airlines has delayed pilot training because of the lack of airplanes.
The Dow from Stiefel's up 108 points, 104 points to 39,418. We've got debris on 44 before Park Avenue North. That's got the right lane closed. Also, slow-moving roadwork on 55 North at Route C. That's got the left lane closed. Some roadwork in the right lane of 5570 at 203 in the Metro East. And 70 East at O.
This afternoon will be mostly cloudy, windy, and quite chilly. High 48. Brisk and colder tonight. Mostly cloudy early, then clearing late. Low 34 downtown at the Arch, but into the upper 20s in the colder north and west suburbs. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Joe Lundberg on the Voice of St. Louis, KMOX.
We've got wind and 42 in Forest, 41 St. Peter's, 43 downtown at the Arch. I'm Michael Calhoun, KMOX News.
Brought to you by Ashley Home Store.
Hey guys, this Friday and Saturday, Ashley is hosting a 48-hour super sale. For 2 days, get 25% off your entire purchase, no matter how much you buy. Hurry in. The 48-hour sale is this Friday and Saturday only at Ashley.
The Chris and Amy Show, sponsored by Summer at SLU. Find your kids' best summer yet at St. Louis University.
Chris Ranji, Amy Mark scores with you on a Tuesday morning. And, you know, there's been some talk about Apple and whether or not it is violating antitrust laws. The Justice Department sued Apple, claiming that the giant is a monopoly and it has a monopoly of the smartphone market. And to give us some insight into the captivating and easily understandable world of antitrust law is Joshua Sisco. He is a reporter at Politico. Joshua, thank you for your time this morning.
Thanks so much for having me.
I loved the way the story in Politico was laid out, just simply six ways the DOJ says Apple is a monopoly, if people want to check it out. Because I think you hear of antitrust law violations potentially, and you listen to some of the arguments, and a lot of it is over our heads. So in, I guess, the simplest terms, what is the Department of Justice's allegations or strongest argument against Apple?
So you're right. It is a very complicated case, but at its heart, it's making the argument that Apple is this vital conduit for commerce, for online commerce, with its app store, with its payment options, banking options. I mean, we just kind of live on our phones. And so because it's this vital conduit for commerce, it has sort of these special obligations in how it deals with rivals and customers. And according to the DOJ and the states who brought the case, that it's using its sort of heft to muscle out those rivals and raise costs for consumers.
So how do you parse between what's competition and trying to have technology they believe to be better versus just making it more difficult for people who are users of other products to cross over? Because I wonder if there is some confusion when it comes to something like that, if that makes sense.
Well, yes. And I mean, that is the heart of the case. And that is what Apple is going to argue, essentially, is that this is its product. It has a right to sort of do business in a manner that it sees fit, and sort of hard-nosed competition, tough business tactics, driving a hard bargain, that sort of thing is totally legal, and it has every right to do that. And the DOJ will counter that, says, well, no, if you reach a certain size and there isn't a finite amount or number that you can place on that size, but if you reach a certain size and if you are important enough in your industry that you have these sort of special obligations to deal with your customers and rivals in a different way. But yeah, that is the magic question, and that will be decided in the court.
Yeah, I wonder that maybe the biggest, the one that people talk about the most as it pertains to Apple and then Android users are the stupid green bubbles. And you lay that out a bit here, because people who have iPhones, they love to shame you if you have an Android. And Apple loves the fact that Apple users shame Android users and bully them into buying iPhones. They have to see green bubbles. They also make the videos pixelated. So when somebody sends you a video, there's all these different things. Now, is that just a business tactic, or is there some real truth to the idea that they're doing that on purpose just to make Androids look inferior?
Well, I think it's both. And that was kind of that teed up. That complaint about the green bubbles that teed up kind of an extraordinary moment when the DOJ announced its case, because at their press conference, you have several high-level Justice Department officials, including Attorney General Merrick Garland, who is sort of going into the complaint about the green bubbles and iMessage and how it's not compatible with Android phones. And it was kind of a striking thing to have the Attorney General focus on that at a press conference. And I mean, Apple's response is, it's our product. We can do, like I said earlier, we can do what we want with it. But if it's steering, it is using iMessage in order to sell more iPhones. And whether that is illegal depends on what kinds of obligations a court decides that Apple has in order to deal with its customers and competitors.
Yeah, I mean, I have an iPhone. Ranj here has the green bubble, and it's such a pain. I mean, we've tried to bully him. We've tried to bully him into getting an iPhone, so I think I'm falling for the tactic, but it's like, oh, the green bubble's irritating. Also, the DOJ talked about apps that are designed for iPhones and that can only be downloaded through the iPhone app store. How much power do you think Apple is exerting over outside developers because of this?
I mean, Apple exerts a tremendous amount of power over developers via the App Store. It's the only, Apple's App Store is the only way to get your app on an iPhone. Unlike Google, where there are, you can have rival app stores, you can download apps off the internet. With Apple, it's the App Store or nothing. And so any app has to go through the company. Apple argues that is meant to keep users safe. It's designed with privacy and security in mind. The DOJ and the company's critics say that's kind of a red herring. And it's, but developers have to go through the company if they want to reach customers with iPhones.
The argument they make about smartwatches working with Apple devices, smartwatches of different companies working with Apple, that they can't do it because there are security concerns. How legitimate is that?
I mean, that is one of the key parts of Apple's argument, is that everything it's doing is with the consumer in mind. It's with your privacy in mind, your security in mind. And it's debatable whether that is the case or not. And that's what will sort of, one of the things that will play out in court. And I can't say whether those concerns are valid or not, but it is the sort of part of the backbone of what Apple is arguing as to why it can conduct business how it has been since, you know, for the last 15, 20 years.
Is it significant at all that this suit was filed in New Jersey?
Yeah, it is actually. The New Jersey piece of this is kind of funny. I mean, it was definitely a strategic move. The Justice Department can bring a case in any federal court where there's harm, and Apple does business in every state, so it could technically bring a case in any state. New Jersey has some good case law for this type of lawsuit. There's a case involving from 10 or more years ago involved that the Justice Department brought involving a fake tooth monopoly, like a denture kind of monopoly. The case law there is sort of beneficial for this case. They also wanted to avoid California, I think, where Epic Games, which recently sued Apple and for antitrust violations in a similar but different, with similar but different claims. Epic largely lost that case, and so that created some bad case law that I think the Justice Department wanted to avoid. So it was definitely strategic to file in New Jersey. And there's also some key witnesses in the area. Verizon and Samsung have corporate offices in the Garden State. And so there will be witnesses that will be nearby, which is one issue if Apple wanted to move the case elsewhere.
And I know the tech world always moves more quickly than the government or laws or the Department of Justice. But do you see the correlation or relationship to back in the 90s, the United States versus Microsoft?
It's a continuation of that argument. Mm-hmm. Apple is going to try to differentiate itself from that case because it'll say in the Microsoft case, DOJ was arguing that Microsoft sort of had this like 90 or more percent monopoly in PC operating systems, whereas the argument it's making for Apple is closer to 60 to 70%. But the DOJ is saying that absent the Microsoft case, companies like Apple and Google would not be where they are today. And so it's going to factor very heavily, I think, in this case going forward.
And I guess, you know, again, as technology evolves, do you think we'll see a similar case like there was a Microsoft case? Now we have the Apple case, that there might be one with like a ChatGPT or AI company?
I think that's a very strong possibility. I mean, the thing with these cases is that they move so slowly. And when you're bringing lawsuits like this in tech markets, it's a big challenge because the tech does move much faster than the law. And it's unlikely that this case is going to go to trial for 3 or 4 years. And then it'll be appealed through the courts. And so it'll take conservatively 6-7 years before it's resolved, the world is going to look a lot different. Mm. Our phones, how we access the internet, how we are, you know, what we use for computing is going to look a lot different in 7 years. And we could very well see a generative AI antitrust case at that point.
Earlier in the month, you had also written about healthcare and the initiative between the FTC and the Department of Justice and Health and Human Services in regard to health costs and how expensive it is for Americans. How likely is something like that going to gain some traction and maybe ultimately actually affect the average person in terms of healthcare costs?
I mean, that is a huge priority for the across the Biden administration, healthcare costs. I think antitrust agencies have one piece of that. But that we're going to see a lot of that over the next 6-8 months as the campaign really, really ramps up those sort of kitchen table issues. And I think antitrust can play a significant role in keeping health costs down. It can break up that sort of concentrated power in healthcare markets that can lead to higher prices. And so it has a big role to play.
He is Joshua Sisco, antitrust reporter at Politico. Joshua, we really appreciate your time today. Thank you so much.
This was great. Thank you so much.
Yep,
take care.
Thank you. You too. Joshua Sisco of Politico. Pretty interesting because I think so much of this is above our heads, that to be able to talk to someone who's been covering it, who understands it in context, whether it's going back to the 90s with Microsoft or forward looking at ChatGPT and such, helps make sense out
Look,
of it.
Look, the way I see it right now, I am just so tired of you green bubble complainers. So whatever
green
they have
bubble
to,
bullies.
Yeah, because I'm not giving in to you.
It's just the videos, man. Yeah. They're so pixelated.
Sorry. That's your problem. It's Chris and Amy. We are expecting at the bottom of the hour a press conference, President Biden to issue a statement on the bridge collapse. So then also the NTSB is expected to hold a press conference just after 12 o'clock, I believe.
So I think we are having our Purina Pups on the Pitch conversation.
There's a puppy out there.
There is a puppy out there.
Bring in the
puppies. When there's a puppy, we don't wait. So we are going to talk to the puppy.
KMOX.
Local news and information direct to your smart speaker. Just say, play KMOX.
What if there is a murderer walking among us?
Follow the clues. Solve the mystery.
This village really is a place where murder is easy.
Agatha Christie's Murder is Easy, a brand new BritBox original series, is streaming now, adding to the largest collection of Agatha Christie, including Miss Marple, Poirot, Why Didn't They Ask Evans, and more.
The whole collection is magnificent.
Stream the best of British TV, only on BritBox. Start a free trial at BritBox.com.
She posted about us just now.
Celebrities can't get enough of Bianna's bespoke skincare line.
She has 147 million followers. How do we monetize?
She needs a social media associate to help her with the hype.
We should repost this. Do we need a hashtag?
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
The Biz Dash is St. Louis's healthiest happy hour, combining fitness, company team bonding, and fun. All levels of runners and walkers welcome. Thursday, May 9th at City Park in downtown St. Louis. Create your company team today at stlbizdash.com.
Have you been wanting to find the secret to losing weight and getting healthy? Hey everyone, it's Dr. Michael Glickert, St. Louis Weight Loss Secret, and we know the secret to losing up to 1 pound of fat every day. Schedule your free consultation to meet with one of our health coaches who will determine which of our custom weight loss programs is right for you. Visit MoWeightLoss.com now to schedule your free in-person or virtual consultation.
This is Debbie Monterey, and when you are really ready to finally lose that weight, call St. Louis Weight Loss Secret. St. Louis Weight Loss Secret helped me to lose 40 pounds. I was so motivated because I was losing 0.5 pound to 1 pound per day. Call St. Louis Weight Loss Secret today. Many patients lose 20 to 30 pounds in about a month or two. For your free private weight loss consultation, call 314-207-8600, 314-207-8600, or online at moweightloss.com.
Wait. Now, wait a little longer. Great. You may have just increased your lifetime income by tens of thousands of dollars. That's how Social Security can work for you. The longer you wait, the more money you may get. Deciding when to start taking your Social Security benefits is one of the most important retirement decisions you'll make. Kyle Jones and Matt Allgaier and the team at FIRA Capital Management, formerly Heisey Advisory Group, can show you the options and help make the right decisions for you and your situation. Call them today, 314-328-4400. You spent decades paying in, optimize what comes out. Kyle Jones and Matt Allgaier and the FIRA Capital Management team can help you squeeze every penny out of your Social Security benefits. Call now, 314-328-4400. That's 314-328-4400. Firm is not affiliated with the U.S. government. Investment advisory services made available through Pine Ridge Advisors, LLC, a registered investment advisor. Securities made available through AE Financial Services, LLC, member FINRA and SIPC.
Stay connected with the heartbeat of St. Louis. KMOX News, bringing you the stories that matter most.
Sunday, April 21st at City Park with City SC. The Pups on the Pitch is happening thanks to Purina. And in studio with us right now, Director of Partnership Marketing at Purina, Angie Mingus. And also Henry is with us. Henry is adorable. Where is Henry?
Henry is right next to me. He knows good people. Oh my gosh, so he has chosen to sit next to me.
Tell us about Pups on the Pitch.
Well, Pups on the Pitch is an event that we're doing with St. Louis City SC at City Park. It's a pet-friendly event where you can bring your dog and your dog can run around the pitch. So fun. It's so fun. We totally believe at Purina that people and pets are better together. And we set out when we did our founding partnership with St. Louis City SC to be the most pet-friendly MLS franchise. And this is just another initiative we have beyond the Purina Club to make sure that we are bringing soccer fans and pets together.
Just for the logistics side of things, how many pups can be on the pitch and what time will the pups be on the pitch? Because I imagine there needs to be time for like a pooper scooper walk behind it before the game.
Well, there's 150 packages that are going to be sold.
Yeah, that's awesome.
But 150 packages, that's two pet parents and the pet. And they're allowed to be on the pitch during two different sessions. One is between 1 and 3, and the other one's between 4 and 6. So tickets will go on sale tomorrow on SeatGeek.com. And so pet parents should jump on SeatGeek.com and get a package and pick their time and bring their pet.
Tickets go on sale at 10 o'clock. In the morning, again, SeatGeek.com. So do you have an idea of how many? So you're going to have about 150 dogs.
150 packages.
So,
two pet parents and a dog are allowed. So yes, about 150 dogs throughout.
Okay. Have you done an event like this before?
We have. So we believe in pet-friendly events all the time. Now, we haven't had them on the pitch, but we have pooches in the ballpark at St. Louis Cardinals. We've done some other pet-friendly events at other MLS teams. So we've had areas that were pet-friendly, but on the pitch, this will be the first.
Oh, that's exciting. I love it. Well, we've been pushing for, I think we need a dog in the newsroom.
We can make that happen.
Because the news, Becky's here. This is the perfect time to pitch this. Because the news is so depressing and it's tough work. Out there, and I think like a therapy dog, a dog that Purina, we could partner.
Can we have Henry
is what I'm saying.
I might have to steal him back, but you can borrow him every once in a while, but we can work on getting you a therapy dog.
I'm actually not even joking, because we've talked about this so much, the power of pets, and you see the healing powers of pets and how it calms people in an environment where there is so much increasing anxiety and people are nervous and people are worried about things. My goodness, sitting with a dog, sitting with a pet really does have healing properties.
It absolutely does. We can bring over our touch therapy team whenever you guys want a little visit. We also do puppy grams, where we bring over a litter of puppies and you can play with the puppies for an hour. So anything that we can do to help with your overall mental health, we are happy to do.
So if people buy a package for Pups on the Pitch, what else do they get besides being there?
Well,
there are some treats. I see treats.
There are some treats. There's going to be a special performance of the Incredible Dog team on the pitch this year. So that'll be great. There's going to be Yappy Hour. So there'll be some treats at Yappy Hour.
And that's what we called the show.
But there'll be tons of little treats and for the dogs, and then of course for the humans as well. But we recommend everyone jump on SeatGeek.com tomorrow, get a ticket package, and come out and enjoy some fun with your pet on the pitch.
So $55, all proceeds benefit the Humane Society of Missouri. That's like a really good deal for a once in a lifetime experience, because if you go to the movie theater, it's that much. For two people, more than that, if you're getting snacks and everything. So this package, again, you can get the tickets at SeatGeek. Is what a fun event. Can I mention that Henry has a purple leash? Can you let people know what the Purple Leash Project is? Because I do love that, too.
Yes. At Purina, we really believe that people and pets are better together. And so we've teamed up with Rover to make domestic violence shelters pet friendly, because we've found that majority of individuals do not leave their abusive situation because they don't want to leave their pets behind. Mm. So we are on a mission to make sure that all pet shelters or all domestic violence shelters are pet friendly so that people can bring their pets along with them.
I love that. I was shocked by the numbers of how many people stay in abusive situations and how abusers will manipulate the victim with the pet. And a lot of times that pet may be the only friend that the victim has. And so really important, the Purple Leash Project. Purina does so much good work for pets and people.
So Pups on the Pitch, Sunday, April 21st. Tickets go on sale tomorrow at 10 o'clock at SeatGeek.com. And also it's May 4th for Pooches in the Ballpark.
Yes, right? May 4th for Pooches in the Ballpark.
It's going to be awesome. I love dogs. I think Henry wants out of here, but he was clawing at the door to get out. So I think he wants to leave. Also, were in the room and saw Becky say yes to the dog.
Yes,
I saw
you
it.
Saw that?
Yeah. I saw
Perfect.
It.
Okay. Well, now we've made it. This is how partnerships are made.
There are five witnesses. Six witnesses.
Studio B is the golf course of KMOX. It's where all the deals go down.
Angie.
I love that.
I know, right?
I love that.
So
Angie Mingus, awesome. Director of Partnership Marketing at Purina, and Henry, thanks for coming in.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's Chris and Amy on KMOX.
Hey guys, Dave from the Dave Glover Show, 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. on KMOX. So coming up on 25 years in the business, and when you ask people what the show is about, they will typically say, oh, I love the show. It's about nothing. It's about everything. It's about chasing mice around Andrew's car. It's about relationships. It's about politics. It's about just smart people being stupid. If you need a break in the afternoon between 1 and 5 p.m., the DJS on KMOX.
Let's talk garage doors. Your garage door. Is it too loud or letting cold or hot air in around the frame? Overhead Door Company of St. Louis will make it all better. In March only, they will perform their full 26-task garage door tune-up for just $79 and just in March. That's just $79 for up to three garage doors and openers. You need this done once a year, so why not now? And for just $79. Schedule now at OverheadDoorsStLouis.com.
This is Christina Strait with Strait Realty reminding you, why pay more than four? In 2003, we had a dream to start a real estate company that would revolutionize the real estate market. Now, 20 years later, after navigating through the many markets' ups and downs, we know exactly how to help you in this challenging time. I'm Christina Strait, owner of Strait Realty. Don't give away your hard-earned equity. Give us a call today, 314-441-4444, 314-441-ALL-4s. And remember, why pay more than four?
Strait Realty is a licensed broker in the state of Missouri.
Hi, this is Charlie Brennan. You know, when you go to the Audiology Center, you'll see a doctor of audiology. And with us right now, Dr. Colleen Bosler. Dr. Bosler, what are some of the signs of hearing loss?
Well, it's a number of things. Sometimes loved ones notice a person asking others to repeat themselves, or the television is too loud. What people tend to notice first with hearing loss is the loss of clarity. They can hear people talking, but they cannot always understand what's being said. That's because the hearing loss can cause you to miss certain consonant sounds, and those consonant sounds give us the detail to the word. A hearing aid can help bring back those details and give you a sense of clarity that you're missing.
Dr. Colleen Bosler at the Audiology Center, with three locations in the greater St. Louis area. Call for an appointment, 636-441-7470, online, theaudiologycenterstl.com.
At 1130, wind and 44 degrees downtown at the Arch. We're expecting the president to speak at any moment on the disaster in Baltimore, but first...
CBS News Special Report. The NTSB is sending a team to Baltimore to assist in the investigation into a ship collision with the Key Bridge there, though it appears the ship's crew had alerted authorities that it lost power, and that proved critical. Maryland Governor Wes Moore.
Many of the vehicles were stopped before they got onto the bridge, which saved lives in a very, very heroic way.
That and the fact it occurred at 1:30 a.m. local time. CBS Baltimore reporter Mike Helgren.
Thankfully, this did not happen a few hours later during the morning rush, but some 30,000 cars cross over the Key Bridge every single day. Thankfully, you know, again, this is a low traffic time, but priority right now is making sure that they get any survivors out of that water.
Six people remain unaccounted for, all believed to be construction workers who were on the bridge repairing potholes at the time. CBS News Special Report. I'm Cammy McCormick.
We've got debris on 44 going north at Park Avenue. The right lane is closed. Some slow-moving road work on 55 north at Route Z. That's got the left lane closed. Cloudy, windy, and chilly today with a high of 48 degrees. Brisk and colder tonight. We'll have some clearing late, low 34 downtown, upper 20s in the outlying suburbs. For tomorrow, a high temperature of 56. Sponsored by Sandberg Phoenix Law Firm. Right now, wind 44 downtown. I'm Michael Calhoun, KMOX News.
At Sandberg Phoenix, we're more than just a law firm. Our attorneys are committed to you, your business, and your community. We are ready to serve you in the areas of business litigation, intellectual property, health law, and products liability. SandbergPhoenix.com. The choice of lawyers is an important decision and should not be based solely on advertising.
Tune in to the Home Improvement Show, sponsored by Mosby Building Arts, Saturdays 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. on KMOX for expert advice on remodeling, design, and construction. This live Q&A show begins at 11 a.m. or find podcasts at MosbyBuildingArts.com.
Broadcasting from the Underlaw Injury Lawyers, GetJim.com Studios,
KMOX.
It's time to roll. After five straight sellout crowds to end last season, Mizzou football is ready to rock again in 2024. Don't miss epic matchups as Auburn, Oklahoma, and Arkansas return to Faurot Field. Lock in your tickets now and join the electric atmosphere with 62,000 of your closest Tiger friends. Call 1-800-CAT-PAWS or visit mutigers.com/tickets to secure yours today. Welcome to the jungle, M-I-Z.
Hey, have you saved more than $300,000 in an IRA or 401k? You may not realize it now, but you've got a big problem on your hands. And that problem is taxes. Learn how you could dramatically reduce the taxes on these accounts in retirement in a one-night adult education class, Retirement Planning 101. It's held at colleges and universities throughout Greater St. Louis and Southern Illinois. And it's hosted by financial and tax architects, your retirement professors. In just 3 hours, you'll benefit from decades of financial planning experience on taxes, healthcare, Social Security, investing for income, and more. If you've saved at least $300,000 for retirement, register now by calling 314-626-8817. You'll pay zero tuition for the class, so call 314-626-8817.
Advisory services offered through Financial Tax Architects, an SEC-registered investment advisory firm. Insurance products and services offered through Financial and Tax Architects.
At Consumer Cellular, you get the same exact coverage as the largest carriers, but for up to half the cost. Same thing, up to half the cost. Up to half the cost for the same thing. 50% the money for 100% the same thing. I hope I'm making myself clear. Consumer Cellular. When freedom calls, we're here to answer. Call us at 1-888-FREEDOM.
Half the cost savings based on cost of Consumer Cellular single line 5 GB data plan with unlimited talk and text compared to lowest cost single line postpaid unlimited talk, text, and data plan offered by T-Mobile and Verizon May 2023.
If you want jazz music, go to New Orleans. Bagels, New York. And for psychics, think California psychics. You want the best, you go to the best. At California Psychics, home of free spirits and open minds, we know better than anyone what makes a good psychic. That's why we guarantee if your reading isn't life-changing, it's free. Visit CaliforniaPsychics.com and experience the joy of certainty. California Psychics.
Dive into all things Cardinals on Cardinals Conversations, your go-to location for exclusive content from KMOX. Catch it on the Odyssey app or your favorite podcast platform. Stay connected with your team. Cardinals Conversations, where the Redbird talk never stops.
We are awaiting President Biden's comments on the bridge accident in Maryland that occurred just after 12 o'clock our time, just after midnight our time. Mm-hmm. And as of right now, one person has been rescued. There is one person who is in serious condition, and there are six who are missing after a massive cargo ship collided with the bridge. Most of the bridge collapsed into the water. They believe the six people who are still missing are construction workers who were on top of the bridge repairing some potholes. So they also say a mayday was sent out from the pilot, from the ship, as soon as they lost power. And apparently they were able to shut down traffic pretty mm-hmm. quick. I wonder how that happens quickly unless they have, and maybe they do. I've never been across this bridge, the Francis Scott Key Bridge. Maybe they have gates that are on either side. Mm-hmm. I don't know if they have something like that, but the fact they were able to stop more cars from getting on to this bridge really avoided a lot of injuries and death.
Well, and it seems that the people that are missing or initially fell into the Potomac River during the bridge collapse were working on the bridge at the time. They were workers. There were three cars and a dump truck and another vehicle that were discovered in the Potomac River. And
Baltimore saying there are five vehicles that they see underwater.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Three cars, a dump truck, and another one. Yep. And so it's really, the video is just shocking. And the mayor of Baltimore pointed out correctly, it does look like the type of bridge collapse that you would see in an action film, end mm-hmm. of world film. Sometimes you see something like this, you hear about a bridge collapse and it's a partial. This is the entire length of the bridge. It, like a domino, just breaks like a toy. It almost looks brittle and flimsy. That's how much an impact the barge had when it hit it and the way it broke.
It's a huge ship. Mm-hmm, they were estimating about 100,000 tons, and it's a cargo ship. It's not like a barge that we would see coming down the Mississippi River. This thing was only almost 1,000 feet long. So it's a huge vessel. And if something like that loses power, depending on the current, there's nothing they can do. And I don't know how the bridge was constructed. I don't know if there were any corners cut. We did have a texter who said it doesn't look like there are any of those islands that you would put around pillars to prevent large ships from running up into the bridge. Again, I don't know if they were there or not. I have no idea. But I'm sure that's a question that's going to be answered. Certainly it's going to be asked, and you can guarantee there are going to be multiple lawsuits as a result of this. But first things first, they have to find the people. They got to find mm-hmm. the people who are missing. And right now they believe there are six of them that are missing. That is, as we talked about at the top of the show, Amy, it's not a great fear of mine, but it's one of those things that is always in the back of my mind every time I cross the bridge to go into Illinois, that something weird's going to happen on this bridge, because it wouldn't be the first time. We had an accident in 1998 near the Eads Bridge. 50 people were hurt in that. There was the Minnesota Bridge collapse. Mm-hmm. That bridge just collapsed on its own mm-hmm. a few years ago. You might remember. The odds of it happening to you, not very good, but still it's terrifying. The thought of it is.
Yeah. Yeah. And with this one, again, you mentioned the ship, how it lost power, and the ship did make an emergency mayday call before it collided with the Francis Scott Key Bridge. It also dropped its anchor prior to impact as part of the emergency procedures because it lost propulsion. It was mm-hmm. not able to steer it on the correct course. And it obviously, with weight like that, momentum like that, it's going to keep going forward. So they made the mayday call. They dropped the anchor. They did what they could. There is no anchor that can stop a container ship like that. And again, it's not a barge like you would see on the Mississippi River. This is an ocean-going massive where it's got the containers like they that are on the 18-wheelers, containers almost, it looks kind of like the ship that got stuck in the canal,
Suez Canal.
And so just the 22 members on crew members on the ship are all okay. That ship is still there. It's still at the site of the collision and it's holding steady. And they're just going to be, I would think, a lot of investigation going on from this point.
Something that is of note, when a ship like that, and I believe that different ports, different states have different laws, but in Maryland, you have to have, and these pilots, once a ship gets close to the harbor, they will go out to that ship, they will board the ship, and then they will steer it into where it docks. And then they will steer it out of the harbor when it's ready to leave. So whoever was piloting the ship does know that area. In fact, it's a requirement. It has to be somebody who is up to date on what's going on wherever they're coming in. So it's not some overseas pilot that didn't know what he or she was doing and crashed into the bridge. It does look like it was power failure. And I mentioned this to you earlier, Amy. I almost don't want to bring attention to it, but I want to, so that I hope we can head it off a little bit, mm-hmm. at least for people who are listening. If you see people like this person who's running for Congress, his name's Anthony Sabatini. He's with Lake County in Florida, tweeted that this was a result of DEI. DEI. Come on.
What?
That's not what it very clearly looks like it was mechanical failure. It's not because of diversity, equity, and inclusion rules. Stop that stuff. What are we talking about?
Yeah, I didn't even.
And this is a person
that.
Running for Congress.
Yeah, no, there are a lot of unserious people, and obviously the pilots of these ships have to be incredibly experienced and to have this type of control of this type of ship. So anyway, it's nonsense. And I think that's going to fade away because it is so very unserious.
And we're expecting maybe over a minute away from President Biden making his remarks. Also, after 12 o'clock, the NTSB is mm-hmm. expected to have a full blown press conference on this accident that occurred in Maryland early this morning.
What's interesting is that the ship, it unmoors from the port at 12:28 a.m. At 1:24 a.m., the lights begin to flicker as it travels down the Patapsco River. And then at 1:26, the ship begins to change course. And from 1:26 to 1:27, the lights continue to flicker. And at 1:27,
you can see it all.
1:27, the ship hits the key bridge. So that changing course, I mean, that'll happen within a minute.
Yeah. And it looks like
within a minute, it changed course and hit the bridge.
Obviously, it's the middle of the night, so the video's dark, but you can see the lights go out a couple of times, which indicates a power loss. And then you see in the middle of it, smoke coming up from, I don't know where it's coming from, but it's from the ship. I just don't know what part of the ship it was coming from. So some sort of accident occurred on board where the power was lost and the result
and also,
was this.
What's interesting, at 1:27, the ship hits the bridge. At 1:40 a.m., the 911 center dispatches call to the fire department. At 1:50, the first fire unit arrives on the scene. Can you imagine being that first fire unit? You are the first emergency responders, and the bridge is just gone.
Yeah, especially if it's a bridge that you've crossed. Mm-hmm. many times in your life.
Because the report was there are several people in the water, so you're an emergency responder. You have no idea what you're going to see.
I imagine, I don't know this, but I'm curious if the people, the crew on the ship are still on the ship, because the boat is there. It is there sitting idly up against what's left of the bridge. So I don't know if the crew is okay. Well, they are okay.
They're okay. All 22 members of the crew are fine.
Don't know if they're there. But that is terrifying. Again, you know, I was half jokingly talking about the McKinley Bridge and how much that thing weirds me out. And I have taken it hundreds of times in my life. And people have texted in about it that there used to be train tracks on the south side where the eastbound lane is now. So imagine the train tracks and cars. Mm-hmm. So all of this going on that bridge. We have an IDOT worker who checked in via the text line and said that he will be driving a snowplow across that bridge with oncoming traffic. And anybody who has been on it knows that is a not a wide bridge.
Yeah.
It's terrifying.
Yeah. So it just a very scary sight. Again, if you haven't seen the bridge collapse, the way the entire thing just crumbles apart as if it's brittle is astounding, honestly. Awful for the six people who are still missing. I know two of the people that were rescued. One was okay and actually wanted to refuse medical treatment. The other one is in needed treatment, was taken to a hospital. So the president will be speaking shortly, will be making a statement. As you mentioned, there's also going to be an NTSB press conference at 12 o'clock, which we will also be carrying.
Yep, we will keep you posted. As soon as this press conference happens, we will bring it to you. We will go to break. If it begins in the middle of the break, we will come out of it and we'll take you to President Biden. Again, the bridge collapse in Maryland and a press conference is upcoming. That's Amy Markscores. I'm Chris Ranji on KMOX.
STL Fence Works has been serving the St. Louis, St. Charles, Franklin, and Warren counties for over 50 years. Russ and Carolyn Long, they opened the company back in 1971. And at STL Fence Works, your satisfaction is their passion. And satisfaction means working with a team that cares about your project as much as you do. It means having confidence in the quality of your new fence or deck, knowing that it was built with the very best materials and workmanship. And for Sean Timothy Long, he's Russ and Carolyn's son. He runs the company now. It's providing for your family.
Amy, let me go ahead. And it looks like the president's remarks are about to begin here shortly. This is on the bridge accident.
An accident that happened in Baltimore this morning. At about 1:30, a container ship struck the Francis Scott Key Bridge, which I've been over many, many times commuting from the state of Delaware in our trainer by car. Been in Baltimore Harbor many times. And the bridge collapsed, sending several people and vehicles into the water, into the river. And multiple U.S. Coast Guard units, which are stationed very nearby, thank God, were immediately deployed along with local emergency personnel. And the Coast Guard is leading the response to the port, where representatives from the Federal Highway Administration, the FBI, the Department of Transportation, the Army Corps of Engineers, as well as Maryland officials and Baltimore Police and Fire, they're all working together to coordinate an emergency response. Officials at the scene estimate eight people were unaccounted for still. Not still, were unaccounted for. That number might change. Two have been rescued, one without injury, one in critical condition. And the search and rescue operation is continuing for all those remaining as we speak. I spoke with Governor Moore this morning, as well as the mayor of Baltimore, the county executive, both United States senators and the congressman. And my secretary of transportation is on the scene. I told them, we're going to send all the federal resources they need as we respond to this emergency. And I mean all the federal resources. And we're going to rebuild that port together. Everything so far indicates that this was a terrible accident. At this time, we have no other indication, no other reason to believe there's any intentional act here. Personnel on board the ship were able to alert the Maryland Department of Transportation that they had lost control of their vessel, as you all know and reported. As a result, local authorities were able to close the bridge to traffic before the bridge was struck, which undoubtedly saved lives. Our prayers are with everyone involved in this terrible accident and all the families, especially those waiting for the news of their loved one right now. I know every minute in that circumstance feels like a lifetime. You just don't know. It's just terrible. We're incredibly grateful for the brave rescuers who immediately rushed to the scene and to the people of Baltimore. I want to say we're with you. We're going to stay with you as long as it takes. Like the governor said, you're Maryland tough, you're Baltimore strong, and we're going to get through this together. And I promise we're not leaving. Here's what's happening now. The search and rescue operation is our top priority. Ship traffic in the Port of Baltimore has been suspended until further notice, and we'll need to clear that channel before the ship traffic can resume. The Army Corps of Engineers is on the spot and is going to help lead this effort to clear the channel. Port of Baltimore is one of the nation's largest shipping hubs. And I've been there a number of times as a senator and as a vice president. It handles a record amount of cargo last year. It's also the top port in America for both imports and exports of automobiles and light trucks. around 850,000 vehicles go through that port every single year. And we're going to get it up and running again as soon as possible. 15,000 jobs depend on that port. And we're going to do everything we can to protect those jobs and help those workers. The bridge is also critical for travel, not just for Baltimore, but for the Northeast Corridor. Over 30,000 vehicles cross the Francis Scott Key Bridge on a daily basis. It's virtually it's one of the most important elements for the economy in the Northeast and the quality of life. My transportation secretary is there now. As I told Governor Moore, I've directed my team to move heaven and earth to reopen the port and rebuild the bridge as soon as humanly possible. And we're going to work hand in hand with the support of Maryland to support Maryland, whatever they ask for. We're going to work with our partners in Congress to make sure the state gets the support it needs. It's my intention that federal government will pay for the entire cost of reconstructing that bridge. And I expect the Congress to support my effort. This is going to take some time. The people of Baltimore can count on us, though, to stick with them at every step of the way until the port is reopened and the bridge is rebuilt. You know, we're not leaving until this job gets done. Not leaving until then. So I just want to say God bless everybody who everyone harmed this morning and their families. And may God bless the first responders, many of whom risked their lives. And the reason I'm not going to take a lot of questions, there's remaining issues that are open that we got to determine what's going to happen in terms of the rescue mission and the like. But
Do you plan to go to Baltimore, sir? And if so, how quickly?
I do, and as quickly as I can.
You said the federal government's also going to pay for the repairs. I'm just curious. This was a ship that appears to be at fault. Is there any reason to believe that the company behind the ship should be held responsible? And then also,
but we're not going to wait for that to happen. We're going to pay for it to get the bridge rebuilt and open.
What did you make of Israel's decision not to attend this meeting this week?
Oh, I don't want to get into that. We've got plenty of time to talk about Rafa.
You mentioned the port. The port, can I ask about cars? About the port.
That is President Biden. After the bridge accident this morning, he did say that he expects the federal government to pay for the accident. They want to get that that lane opened back up as quickly as possible because it is a major shipping harbor for the United States. A lot of goods coming in, a lot of vehicles, a lot of cars coming in, and as expensive as cars have gotten, and I know it's not the single most important thing right now because there are missing people that they still need to find, six of them, in fact. They're saying they want to get this done very, very quickly. The NTSB, Amy, is going to hold a press conference after 12 o'clock.
Yeah. So we'll keep an eye on that. And as you mentioned, there was that question about, well, is the shipping company going to be held responsible? Well, maybe, probably they'll have to look into that, but they can't wait.
For them to
You can't wait for them to pay for it before you start for the repairs, opening the port again. Obviously, a hugely important part of the economy in Maryland.
I suppose the recourse is you pay for it, you get it done, mm-hmm. you get it back up and running, and then you go after the company if they're not willing to pay.
Oh, you've got to get it open, and it's hard to see those images. It's hard to imagine, you know, where, how, if the six people that are, they're still searching for, what their experience may have been. I mean, it's very tragic. It's difficult to watch, actually.
Yeah. And I'm sure there are going to be some people that immediately jump to a political angle here and say, federal government shouldn't pay for this. What do you want them to do? How do you want them to force that company to pay immediately to get the operations up and running to rebuild that bridge?
Yeah, I would hope people don't go straight to the political side, but also, what is government for if not to help in situations like this? I mean, this is a bridge. This is not walking down the street and taking care of your neighbor who's having a hard time and bringing a meal. I mean, this is something that the government has to step in and do and continue life in that area, continue the economy and continue the commerce. So again, we'll keep an eye on the press conference for the NTSB, but pretty shocking news. I grateful it happened overnight. If it's going to happen, that it happens at 1:30 in the morning when there is probably far less traffic on that bridge than there is. I mean, imagine rush hour. Imagine if the commuters had begun their workday, going to work, going to school, or coming home from work, or coming home from school, and how this tragedy could have been amplified even then by the time of day. So, and again, the ship went into emergency procedures as the lights flickered several times, and then it lost power. It did drop an anchor and sent out a Mayday call, but by that point, it was very, very close to the bridge, because from the time that it lost power to the time that it hit the bridge, about a minute. You have 1:26 a.m.
Yeah.
Lost power, 1:27 a.m. collides with the bridge.
And there is some audio. We don't have it yet where we are efforting to get it, but it is, it must be the Maryland Transportation Authority stopping. It's their radio traffic and what was going on at the time. So we haven't heard it yet, but it must be pretty incredible. So if we can get that, we will bring it to you again. NTSB is expected to hold a press conference after 12 o'clock. President Biden was a little bit late, probably about 10 minutes late. So we don't know if this is going to start on time either.
And I don't know if we mentioned this, but I mentioned the Mayday call. And it was the emergency call from the container ship that did give officials time to begin closing the bridge before the ship slammed into it.
There is a texter who says the Francis Scott Key Bridge used to be a toll bridge. So there must be some sort of apparatus there with gates, maybe an attendant that's on either side of it. Again, I've not ever traveled across that bridge. It's a historic site, though, because it's named after, obviously, Francis Scott Key, who was looking into the harbor and wrote the song, the what ended up being the national anthem. So it's a pretty big place in American history. And the accident that happened there today, hopefully they're able to find those six people who are missing that they believe are construction workers. Really, really scary stuff today. So let's take a break now, because when we come back, we do expect the NTSB press conference to begin. It's possible they're not right on time, but we will get to it as soon as it happens. It's the Chris and Amy Show on KMOX.
And right before the president was talking, I was telling you about STL Fenceworks, and just kind of want to finish up that thought. And if you've got your phone, your computer, your laptop, whatever it may be, head on over to stlfenceworks.com. stlfenceworks.com. They really do tremendous work. And you know, when you are investing in your home, you are making one of the bigger investments that you'll make. I mean, your house for most people is the biggest investment that they make. And so you want to know that you're adding quality and craftsmanship. And not only that, not only do you know you'll get quality and craftsmanship with STL Fenceworks, but you're also going to get a lifetime warranty that surpasses anything else in the industry. That's why when they say at STL Fenceworks that your satisfaction is their passion, satisfaction means not only meeting your needs, but exceeding your expectations. And that's exactly what they do at stlfenceworks.com, stlfenceworks.com.
Wow, honey, have you seen the electric bill?
Yeah, it's out of control. But have you heard of Navien tankless water heaters?
Tankless? How does that even work?
Well, instead of constantly heating and storing water, it only heats water when we need it. So much more efficient than our giant tank heater.
That sounds great. Let's look into Navien.
Already on it.
Imagine all the hot water you need only when you need it. Bulky tanks are history. Navien high-efficiency tankless is the future. Compact, wall-hung units free up floor space, lower energy bills, longer life than tanks, and a 15-year warranty. Find out more at tanklessmadesimple.com.
As an educator, Mr. Nelson's teachings are still being quoted in schools.
Education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change the world.
Mr. Nelson taught hope.
Everyone can rise above their circumstances if they are dedicated and passionate.
And giving our best efforts.
It's always impossible until it's done.
Mr. Nelson Mandela's teachings not only united a nation, they inspire us today. Inspiration. Pass it on from PassItOn.com.
KMOX KEZK HD2 K254 CR St. Louis.
The legendary voice of St. Louis, KMOX. Always live on the free Odyssey app.
This is a special alert to all Americans who own a vehicle with less than 200,000 miles with an auto warranty about to expire or with no warranty coverage at all.
Due to a decline in the economy, CarShield is announcing a low-cost, month-to-month vehicle protection plan that is now available to the public to save any driver out-of-pocket expenses on future auto repairs. Call now to find out how you can pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. Yes, you heard that correctly. Pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. An open phone line has been established for all drivers to call for a free quick quote. Call 800-403-5569 now. Drivers who are covered will not have to pay for covered repairs again. This protection plan is at an all-time low. Additionally, drivers who activate this vehicle protection today will also receive free roadside assistance, free towing, and car rental options at no additional cost. Call us for your free quick quote today. 800-403-5569. That's 800-403-5569. What do you have to lose? Call 800-403-5569. Again, 800-403-5569.
Mid-America's most trusted source for news, KMOX.
At 12 noon, we've got windy conditions and 45 degrees downtown at the Arch. I'm Michael Calhoun. Our top story this hour.
Everything so far indicates that this was a terrible accident. At this time, we have no other indication, no other reason to believe there's any intentional act here. Personnel on board the ship were able to alert the Maryland Department of Transportation that they had lost control of their vessel, as you all know and reported. As a result, local authorities were able to close the bridge to traffic before the bridge was struck, which undoubtedly saved lives.
President Biden speaking last hour on the bridge collapse disaster in Baltimore. Now let's get the latest.
CBS News special report. The huge container ship that hit Baltimore's Key Bridge overnight, causing it to collapse, had lost power and sent a Mayday alert. Maryland Governor Wes Moore.
No, once the warning came up and once notification came up that there was a Mayday, who literally by being able to stop cars from coming over the bridge, these people are heroes. They saved lives last night.
Six people are unaccounted for, most if not all believed to be construction workers. The bridge itself had recently been given a fair rating by inspectors. CBS Baltimore reporter Mike Algren.
Not the best ranking, but it had been fair since 2008. There was some concern about the structural pillars, but it still passed the federal inspection. Again, right now the priority is, you know, finding out if anyone is still in the water. Those rescue efforts continue at this hour.
CBS News special report. I'm Cammy McCormick.
The Supreme Court heard arguments today over access to mifepristone, a pill used in abortion. The main argument from plaintiffs is the FDA missed serious safety issues when making the pill more accessible. Dr. Michael Sinha, a professor at the St. Louis University Center for Health Law Studies, says when it comes to the body of research, it is overwhelmingly in favor of safety.
The data are pretty overwhelming. The New York Times reviewed, I think, over 100 studies and found that the incidence rate was something between 0.2 and 0.3%.
Dr. Sinha says there's real concern on the court's decision that this case could stifle federal agency decision-making across the board. The KMOX Business Desk, after a series of recent safety incidents involving Boeing, the company's CEO, Dave Calhoun, announced yesterday he will step down at the end of the year. How could this impact flyers? CBS travel editor Peter Greenberg.
The ramifications here to passengers are also going to be there because the schedules are going to change. If you thought planes were full last year, get ready for even more full planes this year, if that's even possible. And that, of course, can lead to higher airfares.
But will that keep people from flying?
We are a nation right now that cannot stop traveling. That's probably as a result of the pandemic. And we're still doing it. The planes are all full.
The Dow from Stiefel is up 84 points to 39,398. We've got emergency vehicles on 370 westbound at 141. It's got the right lane closed. There's some debris on 44 north before Park Avenue. That's got the right lane closed. And some road work on 5570 going east at Illinois 203. That's got the right lane closed.
Remaining mostly cloudy this afternoon. Windy and quite chilly. High 48. Brisk and colder tonight. Plenty of clouds early. Some clearing late. Low 34 downtown at the Arch, but upper 20s in the coldest north and west suburbs. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Joe Lundberg on the Voice of St. Louis, KMOX.
Right now, we've got wind and 45 in Florissant, 43 St. Peter's, and 45 downtown at the Arch, where the winds are out of the west-southwest at 16, gusting to 30. We are awaiting a briefing from the National Transportation Safety Board, the chair, Jennifer Homendy, on the collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore. That has not begun yet. We are monitoring that, and we'll take you there when they do begin their briefing. For now, I'm Michael Calhoun, KMOX News.
BetterHelp. BetterHelp.com/stop speeding. Are you speeding right now? Do you feel like you're speeding through life, avoiding things you need to face? BetterHelp online therapy can help you slow down and overcome challenges. Visit BetterHelp.com/stop speeding to get 10% off your first month.
The Chris and Amy Show, sponsored by Summer at SLU. Find your kids' best summer yet at St. Louis University. Time to rewind. It's the Chris and Amy Rewind Recap.
We are expecting that NTSB news conference to happen here any moment. As soon as it does, the chair of the NTSB, Jennifer Homendy, expected to address what's happened in Baltimore, Maryland, with the accident of the cargo ship crashing into the bridge and that bridge collapsing as a result of it. Right now, six people are missing. They are believed to be construction workers that were on top of the bridge doing some concrete work, and there were some others rescued, but we don't have any confirmed deaths yet. Mm-hmm. And we'd like to keep it that way, but it doesn't look good at this moment. We'll obviously keep you updated, and as soon as the press conference begins, we'll bring it to you. Also, we have some audio from that. You want to go ahead and hear this now?
Yeah, let's do it now.
Let's do this. So this is the communication. This is the radio traffic where they notified whoever from the ship that there was a problem, that they needed to stop traffic, and they did. And then what happened after it? This is about a minute worth of audio here.
I need one of you guys on the south side, one of you guys on the north side, hold all traffic on the Key Bridge. There's a ship approaching that just lost their steering. So that until they get that under control, we got to stop all traffic.
Yeah, we're all on the route to the south side.
I'm holding traffic now. I was dragging, but we stopped prior to the bridge, so I'll have all out of the traffic stopped.
C-13 dispatch, the whole bridge just fell down. Start is whoever, everybody. The whole bridge just collapsed.
Simple dispatch is direct. That's correct. First time.
Do we know if all traffic was stopped?
I can't get to the other side, sir. The bridge is down. We're going to have to get somebody on the other side of the Anne Arundel County MSP to get up here and stop traffic coming northbound on the T Bridge.
C-13, I'm holding all traffic northbound.
Man.
Jeez. Yeah.
You don't expect, you've said this before, you don't expect an entire bridge to fall down.
Right. I mean, so glad they had the emergency call where they could stop traffic, even if it's briefly. I mean, that's potentially a life saved, being able to stop traffic. But it did happen so quickly, from the time that the power went out on the ship to the time that it was no longer able to steer. It dropped its anchor. Obviously, that can't do anything at the moment. It's just part of emergency procedures. The ship hits one of the pillars of the bridge, and the entire thing goes down. I mean, you can hear, even in the calm, considering everything, the calm voices of those making those emergency calls, the shock when the entire bridge is down, the whole thing is just gone. And it happens in seconds. This is not a long, drawn-out process. You see the ship hit the bridge, and you see it just absolutely crumble.
Yeah, this is, that's really terrifying. And yeah. You've seen bridges, barges. We've seen barges hit our bridges in the past. Remember the flood of 93? There were a couple that smashed into it. I believe a Taco Bell boat. But those were tiny boats in comparison.
This is an ocean-going ship, container ship.
Almost 1,000 feet long. It was over 900 feet long.
So it's like 3 football fields, 3.5 football fields. Yeah.
So the press conference, we are being told now, here's the update. It's going to happen at 1:30 our time. So not at 12:30. It is happening at 1:30. That's when the Dave Glover hour takes over. So we do expect to be bringing that to you. Mm-hmm. But man, this is.
Yeah.
It's awful.
So we'll keep you updated.
And a lot of lives saved, by the way, by those actions, by the men we played the radio traffic. A lot of people got saved because they quickly acted. They called for the Mayday right away, and they were able to close off both ends of the bridge.
Yeah.
Could have been a whole lot worse. And thankfully,
it happened in the middle of the night and not during rush hour.
No,
this could have been really, really bad.
Yeah. The ship is still there where the collision first occurred. All 22 members, crew members of the ship, they are safe. And anyway, we'll keep you updated with anything that any breaking news regarding that. And of course, the NTSB will have its press conference now that time has been changed to 1:30 Central Time.
Yep. So KMOX will have that for you. Let's do this, Amy. I want to take a break. I want to come back because there are some things we didn't get a chance to get into because of the breaking news today. And we will do that on the Chris and Amy show. We also want to hear from you. 314-436-7900. It's Chris and Amy on KMOX.
And if you would like to join me, and you do, on Saturday, April 20th for the 2024 Work Zone 5K, here's what you need to do. Just go to the website that I am on right now, mo.org/stlewis. mo.org/stlewis. I've, for several years now, I think, been involved with MoDOT and their Work Zone Awareness Week to raise awareness for work zones, which I know we see work zones on our roads and the highways and we think, oh, there's going to be traffic. But here's the thing. Those workers in the work zones, they are mothers and fathers and wives and husbands and sisters and brothers. And they are working all day long, all night long to make sure that they can keep our roads safe, make those roads safer, repair the roads so that we can get home safely and our cars get home in good shape. Let's make sure that they can go home safely as well. When you're going through a work zone, just remember to slow down, put your phone down, pay attention, because again, it's our neighbors, those are the people working on our highways, and to help raise money for those workers who have been injured or killed on the job, raise money for their families. We can do the Work Zone 5K, celebrate the workers and celebrate the lives of those who have lost their lives. The 2024 Work Zone 5K is Saturday, April 20th. It starts at 8 a.m. right there at 1:41:40. MoDOT.org/stlewis. MoDOT.org/stlewis.
For everything online, it's Odyssey.com. Download the Odyssey app and listen to KMOX for all the news, sports, talk, and podcasts that move you. Odyssey. That's AUDACY.
The choice of a lawyer is an important decision and should not be based solely on advertisements.
If you've been injured in a car wreck, you need the best. Let us make your case our cause. Car accident? Call Onder Law for a free review at 314 or 618-9000.
We all hear the radio ads about the IRS. They tell you to be afraid, to be scared, and they try to frighten you into calling. I'm not here to do that. Tax Relief Advocates is different. TRA is here to tell you that if you owe money to the IRS, whether it's $5,000, $50,000, or $500,000, we have a solution. It doesn't matter if you're sitting in your car, at work, or with your kids, no matter where you are, call now. 800-575-6481. Don't lose hope. TRA can eliminate or reduce what you owe to the IRS. There is zero risk to you. If we can't reduce your tax debt, then you pay nothing. Our passion is taxes and helping individuals fix their IRS problems. We have a 5-star rating on Google and Yelp and an A+ with the Better Business Bureau. You don't need to be afraid of the IRS any longer. End your tax nightmare today by visiting us online at TRA.com or call 800-575-6481. That's 800-575-6481. Tax Relief Advocates. Real solutions for real people.
Let's talk garage doors. Your garage door. Is it too loud? Or letting cold or hot air in around the frame? Overhead Door Company of St. Louis will make it all better. In March only, they will perform their full 26-task garage door tune-up for just $79 and just in March. That's just $79 for up to 3 garage doors and openers. You need this done once a year, so why not now? And for just $79. Schedule now at OverheadDoorsStLouis.com.
The Biz Dash is St. Louis's healthiest happy hour. Combining fitness and fun, it's a perfect team bonding activity for any size business. All levels of runners and walkers are welcome. Join us this spring at City Park, the home of St. Louis City SC. With music, food, drinks, and more, the Biz Dash is the ultimate office party. Thursday, May 9th at City Park in downtown St. Louis. Create your company team today at stlbizdash.com.
Getting your biggest tax refund from Jackson Hewitt can lead to some spirited reactions.
Jackson Hewitt, yeah!
Jackson Hewitt is so sure they'll get you your biggest refund that if they don't, you get your money back plus $100.
Jackson Hewitt, yeah!
Switch to Jackson Hewitt and we'll beat what you paid last year, even if you filed online.
Hewitt, yeah!
Ain't nothing to it. Switch to Jackson Hewitt and pay less for tax prep, guaranteed. Proof of prior year payment required when filing. New clients only at participating locations through April 7th. Terms at jacksonhewitt.com.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same, but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online? Go to hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation, discreet shipping if prescribed, and the process is 100% online. To start your free online visit, go to hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy.
Grab your golf squad and get ready to scramble. Join the party at Ballpark Village's first ever Dirty Birdie Classic on Saturday, April 13th. Teams of four will get to compete in nine festive mini golf challenges throughout Ballpark Village for a chance to win $1,000 in cash. Featuring bogey buster competitions, select drink menus, best dressed prizes, and more. For tickets and event details, head to stlballparkvillage.com/events.
Retiring soon? Get the information you need by joining Kyle Jones and Matt Allgaier of FIRA Capital Management for your retirement highway, Sunday mornings at 9:30. Investment advisory services made available through Pine Ridge Advisors, LLC, a registered investment advisor. Securities made available through AE Financial Services, LLC, member FINRA and SIPC.
Hey, it's Bo Matthews for Reinhold Electric. You know, spring storms are definitely a-coming, right? Don't get left in the dark. Reinhold Electric is here to help. Of course, they have 24-7 emergency service, but if you're thinking about a backup generator, like an inline one that comes on when the power goes out, Reinhold Electric is absolutely who you want to call. Be prepared for the spring storms. Call Reinhold Electric today. 314-631-1158. Online at reinholdelectric.com. Wherever you hear my voice, Reinhold Electric is going to keep you electrified.
Hey guys, Glover here with my very, very good friend, Dr. Kathy Maupin at BioBalanceHealth.com. If you have reached that certain age and you're just not feeling very well and nothing's working the way it used to work, go see Dr. Kathy. She is not only a medical doctor, she is a patient of this bioidentical hormone replacement therapy. It absolutely works. It's a long-term solution. She is an artist when it comes to helping you with your hormones. BioBalanceHealth.com for Dr. Kathy Maupin.
Do you have heart failure and often hear,
"Those stomach issues ruined your birthday.
You're too tired to play catch, Grandpa."
Sweetie, you haven't touched your tool since the carpal tunnel syndrome diagnosis.
If these seemingly unrelated symptoms sound familiar, talk to your cardiologist. Ask about transthyretin amyloid cardiomyopathy, or ATTR-CM, a rare and underdiagnosed disease that gets worse over time. Learn more at yourheartcomesfirst.com. That's yourheartcomesfirst.com. Sponsored by Pfizer.
Schedule your free tree inspection from Gamma Tree Experts now. I'm Tim Gamma. Our certified arborist and horticulturist are ready to meet you in preparation of the coming season. Winter is always hard on a lot of trees here in St. Louis. If you have a tree that you're really concerned about, let us come take a look at it for free. I'm Tim Gamma. Give me a call at 725-6159. That's 314-725-6159. Your trees deserve the best care from Gamma Tree Experts.
The Doctors of Ophthalmology Associates are pleased to welcome Dr. Samuel Berry to the practice. He joins Drs. Birdie, Malhotra, Brasati, and Royer as the Doctor's Doctors. 314-966-5000 or youreyedoc.com.
Mike Miller hosts the Garden Hotline, Saturday mornings at 8 on The Voice of St. Louis, KMOX.
The NTSB press conference has been changed. It's happening after 1:30 now, or at 1:30, originally supposed to be 12:30. So it will happen in the next hour. In the meantime, it's Amy Marks Kors and Chris Ranji with you. John Ondrasik with the band Five for Fighting. Remember that band?
The Superman song.
Which was a really big, it's kind of a hit right after 9/11. Yeah. So that is, he's coming up at 12:30 now. We're going to be talking to him. Mm-hmm. So yesterday, Amy, we've been following what's going on with Shohei Ohtani. And the Cardinals will be facing the Dodgers this week. Opening day is Thursday.
Without Sonny Gray. Without Dylan Carlson.
Do we know that for sure on Dylan Carlson?
Oh, I thought maybe not.
I don't know if we know that.
That's false news.
Well, don't.
That's speculation.
Please don't do that. Because then we'll get calls. We're going to get calls.
We are going to get calls.
So Shohei Ohtani has been caught up in this betting scandal when his interpreter last week was given an interview talking about how he had a gambling problem and originally said that Ohtani helped him out because he's a friend. Ohtani's people backtracked and said, no, we didn't. He stole the money. So this has been his interpreter for years since he's been in the United States. So it's really, it seems like a massive deal.
And the money that they're referring to is $4
million. $4.5 million.
Ballpark, $4.5 million. So not chump change. And I've got a lot of questions. And I know you'll cover. Why don't we go over what Ohtani says yesterday? Because I do have questions about that.
So here is Ohtani speaking through his new interpreter. And by the way, the Dodgers fired the old one. This is him speaking through his new interpreter. It's edited because they were alternating on the dais. Ohtani would speak. The interpreter would speak. Ohtani would speak. The interpreter would speak. So we just put all of this. This is the English version. This is his interpreter speaking for Shohei Ohtani.
I never bet on baseball or any other sports, or never have asked somebody to do it on my behalf. And I have never went through a bookmaker to bet on sports. Up until a couple of days ago, I didn't know that this was happening. Just to kind of just go over the result, in conclusion, Ipe has been stealing money from my account and has told lies.
So Shohei Ohtani denying any part of either helping out his interpreter friend pay off the $4.5 million in gambling debts and denying any gambling himself on any sports whatsoever, which, by the way, as a side note, Major League Baseball players are allowed to bet on other sports, just not baseball.
But they are not allowed to go through these bookies, which is what this guy was doing.
Right.
That's illegal.
Not allowed to go through bookies. And my question is, if it's true that the interpreter initially lied to Shohei's representatives when the representatives made a statement saying that Shohei had helped his friend pay off these gambling debts, and they said, no, that's a lie. His interpreter was stealing directly from Shohei. My question is, how did the interpreter steal directly, make direct withdrawals from Shohei's account? Because I have a lot of good friends. I have a fiance. We don't have the same bank account. Like, the only time I know when people really have direct access to a checking account is like if you're married, right? When we get married, sure, that's going to happen. I don't know. No one. My parents don't have access to my checking account. My fiance doesn't. Nobody does. Is it normal that an interpreter would have access to his account? And secondly, he was making payments, I believe, in $500,000 lumps. So $500,000 lumps, and Shohei didn't notice that. His accountants didn't notice that, because when you have a lot of money, you're going to have maybe people taking care of your finances. You would think that they would pay better attention to it. So, and he hasn't gotten his huge contract yet, but he still has millions and millions of dollars.
Right. And because he gets a lot through endorsements, and he is very highly paid, even though most of his $700 million contract is not kicking in for a decade. Mm-hmm. Lisa Guerrero, who was married to a baseball player, you've probably seen her. She's a media personality. She was tweeting about this yesterday, and she said, you would be surprised with some of these guys, some of these players, how little they know about their finances, who's taking what, who's doing what with whatever they have, or how much they actually have, because they just want to play baseball. They don't want to worry about it. So maybe, and especially for Ohtani, somebody who does not speak English well, it is not his first language. Maybe he did entrust his friend, a guy he thought was his friend,
to
manage a lot of that stuff working in America. So that, I don't know how to feel about this, because my instinct is to say, I think he probably didn't do anything wrong here, but you really never know. Mm-hmm. I can't say for a fact that Ohtani was betting on his own games. And now you got these internet sleuths, which is one of the problems, who are going to go through all of his games and try to see if they can match up bets that were placed on certain days and him having a bad game. I think it's a really difficult chore, especially because his numbers are ungodly. So it's difficult to make the argument that he's throwing baseball games or altering his play because he has a bet on one of his on one of the games he played in. I tend to think he probably didn't do any of that. But again, I don't know that for a fact. We don't really know a lot about him as a person. He doesn't do a ton of press conferences. He doesn't speak to the media a lot, as a lot of guys who don't have English as their primary language do.
And I mean, I've made goofy decisions. I'm naive in certain areas. And so, you know how if you're naive, you think, oh my gosh, if something had gone wrong, 100% people would look at me and go, well, what did she think would happen? That was so naive. So maybe he did entrust his friend, an interpreter who had been friend for a long time, with his accounts. And maybe that's like, okay, well, I really trust you. Will you oversee things? Not that his friend was his or interpreter what would be the accountant, but maybe the friend worked with the accountants and therefore had direct access, or could have said, hey, Shohei wants you to wire this much money here. Or, so maybe that's how he did it. I don't know.
Or then we have a texter who says maybe the interpreter went with whoever handles the money to the bank and does have access to passwords and everything else, because he had to do some of these transactions because they're being done in English. There's no telling. It's still not good for baseball, and investigations will be ongoing for a long time. When we come back, John Ondrasik with Five for Fighting. The band is joining us next on KMOX.
Are you the decision maker in your company? Consider this. For the first time in decades, there's a better option for a corporate card and spend management platform. Meet Ramp, the only corporate card and spend management system designed to help you spend less money so you can make more. Most corporate credit cards offer points as incentives, but those points amount to less than their worth in real cash value. Ramp's corporate cards offer you cash back, real money in your pocket. Plus, you control who spends what with each vendor. And Ramp's software collects and verifies receipts automatically, which means you'll stop wasteful spending and close your books in hours instead of days. Businesses that use Ramp add up to 5% to their bottom line the first year. If you're a decision maker, adding Ramp could be one of the best decisions you've ever made. And now get $250 when you join Ramp. Just go to ramp.com/free. ramp.com/free. ramp.com/free.
Cards issued by Sutton Bank and Celtic Bank, members of FDIC. Terms and conditions apply.
Have you been wanting to find the secret to losing weight and getting healthy? Hey everyone, it's Dr. Michael Glickert, St. Louis Weight Loss Secret, and we know the secret to losing up to 1 pound of fat every day. Schedule your free consultation to meet with one of our health coaches who will determine which of our custom weight loss programs is right for you. Visit moweightloss.com now to schedule your free in-person or virtual consultation.
This is Debbie Monterey, and when you are really ready to finally lose that weight, call St. Louis Weight Loss Secret. St. Louis Weight Loss Secret helped me to lose 40 pounds. I was so motivated because I was losing a half a pound to a pound per day. Call St. Louis Weight Loss Secret today. Many patients lose 20 to 30 pounds in about a month or two. For your free private weight loss consultation, call 314-207-8600, 314-207-8600, or online at moweightloss.com.
We're going abroad for the first time in years, to Spain.
But we don't speak Spanish.
So we started using Babbel.
And started learning Spanish fast.
With Babbel, you can start having conversations in another language in just 3 weeks. Babbel's conversational method teaches you real-life words and phrases. And with Babbel's interactive bite-sized lessons, you'll remember what you learned.
¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
¿De dónde eres?
¿De dónde eres?
When you learn a language, you want to actually use it. Babbel is designed with that goal in mind.
In just 3 weeks, we're starting to have conversations in Spanish.
Estoy muy emocionado para ir a España contigo.
Aw, he just said, I'm very excited to go to Spain with you. Nos vamos a divertir mucho.
And that means we're going to have a lot of fun.
Sí. Gracias, Babbel.
Babbel, language for life. Celebrating 10 million subscriptions sold. Now try Babbel for free at babbel.com.
Just go to Babbel.com and start learning a new language today. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
The final days of the construction sales event are going on now at Audi Exchange Kirkwood. Stop in today and choose from hundreds of new Audis. And right now, take up to 10% off MSRP and get special low-rate financing on our great selection of new Audis. Coming soon in April, we're excited to introduce the all-new Audi Exchange Kirkwood, complete with over 35,000 square feet of nothing but Audi and a new attitude. Visit AudiKirkwood.com.
Warmer spring weather is right around the corner, and now is the time to plan your home's exterior renovation project. Banner Construction is booking now for homeowners to be first in line for beautiful James Hardy siding and Pella replacement windows. Beat the price increases and plan your project now. Visit BannerConstruction.com or call 314-569-1050 and get a free in-home design and estimate. 314-569-1050 and have a banner day.
Got winds out of the west southwest at 16. It's currently 45 degrees downtown at the Arch.
CBS News special report. President Biden is addressing last night's bridge collapse in Baltimore.
The mobile U.S. Coast Guard units, which are stationed very nearby, thank God, were immediately deployed along with local emergency personnel.
At the White House, Caitlin Huey Burns.
He was briefed by senior staff members, and he directed his staff to direct all resources that they need and are being asked for in terms of the search and rescue efforts.
It was a container ship that hit the Key Bridge. It had reported losing power, which helped authorities get vehicles off the bridge, but construction workers were still there. CBS Baltimore reporter Mike Helgren.
There was a warning. There was enough time to warn people to get the vehicles off that bridge, but right now our hearts are with the families of those construction workers. And
six people remain unaccounted for. CBS News special report. I'm Cammie McCormick.
Bloomberg's Joan Doniger lives in the area, joined us this morning.
It's unthinkable. It's absolutely horrific in terms of right now what it does for you know, obviously for the people of Baltimore. It makes commuting a lot more difficult.
We've got emergency vehicles reported on 370 West at 141. The right lane closed there, and some road work happening on 5570 going east to 203. That's got the right lane closed. And the forecast this afternoon, windy, chilly, cloudy, high 48. For tonight, brisk and colder, cloudy early, clearing late with a low 34 downtown, upper 20s in the colder north and west suburbs. And for tomorrow, sunny, milder in the afternoon with a high of 56. Right now, we've got wind and 45 degrees downtown at the Arch. I'm Michael Calhoun, KMOX News.
Brought to you by Ashley Home Store.
Hey guys, this Friday and Saturday, Ashley is hosting a 48-hour super sale. For 2 days, get 25% off your entire purchase, no matter how much you buy. Hurry in. The 48-hour sale is this Friday and Saturday only at Ashley.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Today, we're the largest injury firm in the world, and I'm thankful to you for trusting us all these years. We'll always be here for the people, not the powerful. We'll always be here for you. Morgan & Morgan.
Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Broadcasting from the Underlaw Injury Lawyers, GetJim.com Studios.
KMOX.
Hey guys, Glover here for my friends at UniversalWindowsDirect.com. How do you not like a company whose product was developed by NASA so that the window stays warmer around the edges, so that we can give you a lifetime warranty, and so that you can pass that on to whoever buys your house, a 30-year warranty for them? Mention me, get two windows when you buy two windows, get four when you buy four, get 20 when you buy 20. That's UniversalWindowsDirect.com, 314-334-2522.
The Cardinals open the 2024 season Thursday against the Dodgers in L.A. John Rooney and Ricky Horton have the call. Amron pregame show 215. First pitch 310. Hear it here on your home of the St. Louis Cardinals. King of OX.
We are not.
It's a Chris and Amy show on KMOX. It is good to have you with us this afternoon. And it is time to go to the Quiver River Electric guest line. We bring in our guest, who you just heard there, the lead singer for Five for Fighting, the band that has been around for quite some time. John Ondrasik is with us on KMOX. Good afternoon, John.
Hey, Chris, how you doing?
Hey, we're doing okay. Wanted to talk about your project that you have going on right now, and that is the Music Matters Challenge, which starts today. It launched today. So tell us more about that and what it means.
Well, thanks for asking. I think we all can agree that, you know, music is critical for our kids in schools. And it's very personal to me. When I was in elementary school and LA Unified cut funding, my mom volunteered and came into our sixth grade class and started putting on full musicals. I was Tony in West Side Story, so make of that what you will. Mm-hmm. We've launched a national contest to make sure that every kid has a music teacher in their schools. The Music Matter Challenge was inspired by a song that I wrote with some Chicago inner city kids that did not have a music teacher. The song was called Let Music Fill My World. And through that process, we raised enough money to provide a music teacher for that school for 3 years. And now we're doing a national competition where everybody, you don't have to be a singer, you don't have to be a musician, can tell a story about a music teacher that made a difference in their lives, sing a little bit of Let Music Fill My World or play it on an instrument, and enter the Music Matters Challenge on the Let Music Fill My World website. And we'll have 10 finalists. The public will vote, and the winner will win $10,000 and participate in funding another music teacher for 3 years. And there's a school prize for a $25,000 grant. So it's just a lot of fun where everybody can participate. I call it an ice bucket challenge for music in the schools. And we're really excited and appreciate you're the first interview I've done since we launched. So we get to launch it in St. Louis.
This is fantastic. We
Excellent.
Always try to be first.
We do. St. Louis is not always known for being first.
Well, except for like murder rate or whatever. But hey, it's fine. We want to be first in something else. So this is awesome.
Hey, speaking of firsts, I will say on April 1st, you'll be at the City Winery performing.
So excited. You know, it's I've been blessed through this a long time. And we always have such wonderful shows in St. Louis. We talk about the Cardinals. I was actually playing a show in St. Louis when the Cardinals won the World Series. We literally brought down the screen and watched the final out. So I have a lot of fun memories in St. Louis. And I'm bringing an amazing string quartet with me. They're incredible Broadway players. My violin player, Katie, just won a Tony. And it adds a dimension to, you know, my songs like 100 Years and Superman and Chances. And it's a very intimate show. It's a family show. We always do a song to recognize our troops. So we'll have some wine at the City Winery. So what could be better?
Well, no, City Winery ain't bad. It's a really cool place. And you'll love it. You know, that song Superman that you mentioned, it was kind of a big deal going back to the immediate aftermath of September 11th. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people really attached themselves to that song and really felt something because of the message, and because, you know, there were so many heroes on that day that we talk a lot about, that people really felt something with that song. What did that mean for you?
It was surreal. You know, I was in London on 9/11. I didn't realize till I got back to the States that Superman had become, you know, one of the songs recognizing the heroes of 9/11. And, you know, I just played a show the other night in New York City and played Superman. And, you know, 22 years later, there's still a weight and a kind of solemn reverence when I play that song in New York City and DC. And, you know, as a songwriter, you can never imagine something like that happening. You would never want something like that to happen. But, you know, it kind of reminds us of how songs can, you know, transcend and make a difference. And when I played the concert for New York, I'll never forget The Who coming out and blowing the roof off Madison Square Garden and allowing all those emergency workers a chance to release, to cry, to scream, to sing. So I think it really shows how music, you know, is so unique in our wellness and in our history.
Well, looking at the lyrics of your songs, very poetic. introspective. They are, in some cases, existential, right? Like making people think, did you have a background or an enjoyment of poetry and literature going into your songwriting career? Because it's not typical pop music. It's very, very literary and poetic.
Yeah, my literary background was Stevie Wonder and Led Zeppelin. you know, and you know, I think, you know, if you look at songs like 100 Years,
yeah,
you know, they're kind of post-it notes to myself. You know, it's about appreciating the moment, you know, living in the moment, and something I think I struggle to do, and I know folks struggle to do. And so I think a lot of the songs are sentiments that we feel every day. Maybe I put them, I say that a little differently, but I think they're kind of like Superman. You know, it's not easy to be me. It's about our common humanity. So maybe I just phrase it a little different, but I think the underlying kind of premises of the songs are things you feel every day, and maybe why, you know, 20 some years later, people still sing them back to me.
I wonder about that, because sometimes when you talk to actors, they will get salty if you bring up something they did 20 years ago, and they'll say, well, hey, I've got new stuff too. Why don't you why don't you talk more about my new stuff? Do you feel that way about music?
You know, the fact that I actually get to live my childhood passion, and, you know, 20 years later, people still buy a ticket, and to have a few songs people know, I mean, how can you complain about that? I mean, I understand. Look, I have new songs. They resonate in different ways. But the things I've seen with Superman in 100 Years and the platform it has given me to shine light on various causes, to play for our troops, to raise money for you know, great charities, it's a true blessing. And yeah, we all, you know, hopefully my best song is still ahead of me. But I certainly still enjoy playing those songs, and I do not take it for granted at all.
Do you see your time, you went to UCLA in the 80s. Do you see your time at UCLA as totally separate from your music career, or was there a good music scene? Did you get any influences there?
Well, I went to UCLA. I was a math major, so I could get a job when my music thing collapsed. Wow. And I'm still waiting for that to happen. But and I had my studio in my dorm, and I was writing songs and recording songs. So I was still pursuing my music at school. But, you know, I felt I owed it to my parents, who supported me throughout, you know, kind of my early years to get a degree. And certainly with music, there's no guarantee. And it actually gave me certain freedom to really go out and do it my own way, write the songs I wanted to write, and, you know, rise or fall on their merits. But yeah, I still have great memories of that time. And I would always, you know, the best thing about, you know, being a aspiring singer-songwriter in college is you can, you know, sing a little Journey at a frat party, and maybe some girl will talk to you.
That's what it's all about, right? That's what people get into music for. Yeah, to talk to ladies. If you want to enter the music contest that we were talking about right at the beginning, Music Matters Challenge, the website is letmusicfillmyworld.com. We're talking to John Ondrasik with Five for Fighting. He will be at City Winery on April 1st. And if you want tickets for that, fiveforfighting.com. It should be a really nice time. You're going to like that venue also. It's intimate. It's really, really cool. So we appreciate your time, John. Thank you for talking. Thank you for making us first today.
You're always first. Go Cardinals. I'll see you guys next week. Yes. Thanks so much.
Excellent. Thank you.
That's it. That's John Ondrasik with Five for Fighting, again at City Winery on April 1st. Fiveforfighting.com for tickets to that. And by the way, we do have some news on Cardinals outfielder Dylan Carlson.
Okay.
We believe we're going to talk with Matt Pauly here in a few moments. We'll get the latest.
Well, oh, no. Did you hear something?
I've heard something.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. And Matt Pauly, don't know how. Well, we'll let Matt Pauly fill us in. That's coming up on KMOX.
Just imagine being walked all over for 36 years. Who would do that? The great customers of Reinhold Flooring, that's who. For over 3.5 decades, Reinhold Flooring has been the mecca for carpet, hardwood, vinyl, laminate, and area rugs. Reinhold Flooring is customer-driven with a focus on top-quality products and installations from the best team in the business. So come on in and walk all over your next flooring at Reinhold Flooring. Visit them at 5429 Telegraph Road in St. Louis or online at reinholdflooring.com.
Spring into your next project with a first-line home equity loan from First Community. Apply by April 30th and get an amazing introductory rate of 5.95% APR for the first 12 months. And there is no application fee and no closing fees, only at First Community. $1 share deposit required. Must qualify for membership. Subject to credit approval. Offer does not include refinances on First Community loans. Call 888-642-7969 for terms and conditions.
KMOX Kegs and Eggs, presented by Budweiser, returns to 7th Street in downtown St. Louis before the home opener Thursday, April 4th. Tickets are sold out, but through March 31st, you have a chance to win a pair of tickets. Submit your email address on the Kegs and Eggs contest page and click Submit. Come celebrate this unofficial holiday with Dirt Cheap, Aloha Pools USA, Rally House and Victory Men's Health, a men's health clinic dedicated to health optimization. Details at KMOX.com/contest.
Let's save lives. An introduction to suicide prevention is an education program designed by and for the Black community. To learn more, go to afsp.org/chapters. AFSP is an I'm Listening partner. Learn more at imlistening.org and on the Odyssey app.
This is Christina Strait with Strait Realty reminding you, why pay more than four? In 2003, we had a dream to start a real estate company that would revolutionize the real estate market. Now, 20 years later, after navigating through the many markets' ups and downs, we know exactly how to help you in this challenging time. I'm Christina Strait, owner of Strait Realty. Don't give away your hard-earned equity. Give us a call today, 314-441-4444, 314-441-ALL-4s. And remember, why pay more than four?
Strait Realty is a licensed broker in the state of Missouri.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle, unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now you can try it for free at ziprecruiter.com/free. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Hey, this is Charlie Brennan. If you have exposed brick or stone in your garage, basement, or fireplace, this is a great time to call Morelli Tuck Pointing. Of course, tuck pointing on the outside of your house is often not possible in the winter, but inside, the Morelli team can keep working 12 months a year. What's tuck pointing? Well, it's the removal of old mortar and the replacement of new mortar on a wall or chimney. Sometimes that mortar can become loose, missing, or deeply eroded. We've used the Morelli team to tuck point the Brennan home numerous times. So if you live in a brick or stone home in need of repair, call the company that's received the Angie's List Super Service Award every year, back to back to back, since 2005. Morelli, the masonry specialists. Check out their reviews on the Google, Angie's List, and Better Business Bureau websites. Call 314-645-1387. MorelliTuckPointing.com.
I'm Dave Glover, and I see clearly now thanks to the doctor's doctors, Dr. Greg Birdie, Ranjan Malhotra, Robert Broussardi, Andy Royer, and Samuel Barry. You can too. Just go to youreyedoc.com.
Tune in to the Home Improvement Show, sponsored by Mosby Building Arts, Saturdays 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. on KMOX for expert advice on remodeling, design, and construction. This live Q&A show begins at 11 a.m. or find podcasts at mosbybuildingarts.com.
Hey! Have you saved more than $300,000 in an IRA or 401k? You may not realize it now, but you've got a big problem on your hands. And that problem is taxes. Learn how you could dramatically reduce the taxes on these accounts in retirement in a one-night adult education class, Retirement Planning 101. It's held at colleges and universities throughout Greater St. Louis and Southern Illinois. And it's hosted by financial and tax architects, your retirement professors. In just 3 hours, you'll benefit from decades of financial planning experience on taxes, healthcare, Social Security, investing for income, and more. If you've saved at least $300,000 for retirement, register now by calling 314-626-8817. You'll pay zero tuition for the class, So call 314-626-8817.
Advisory services offered through Financial Tax Architects, an SEC registered investment advisory firm. Insurance products and services offered through Financial and Tax Architects.
Amy Marks scores.
This is my show, my microphone.
On KMOX.
Here's the sidestep, the kick, the pitch, a swing, and that's hit hard. Deep right center field. On the run, Carlson, and Carlson trips over Walker. The ball goes to the wall. It's in play. Walker is slow to pick it up, and on to third. Horner, he has a triple. And Carlson is down at the base of the wall in right center field.
That collision happened yesterday. Dylan Carlson left the game early, and we got word that his shoulder was bothering him. We now have more evidence. We have more to go on because Matt Pauly is with us, and he will tell us what the latest is on Cardinals outfielder Dylan Carlson. Matt, on the Quiver River Electric guest line, what's the deal?
Yeah, so it was just announced a few moments ago that Dylan Carlson has a sprained AC joint in his left shoulder. He will start the season on the injured list. His absence is expected to be weeks, so this is not some type of season-ending situation. But so weeks is better than months, but he is still not going to be available to start the season.
So what's the injured list look like now?
There's a bunch of guys. So Tommy Edman, Lars Nootbaar, Keenan Middleton, Sonny Gray.
And now
Dylan Carlson.
So taking his place on the roster is Victor Scott. And that's a guy that a lot of people kind of wanted him to make the team out of camp anyway.
Yeah. So Victor Scott is the fourth ranked prospect in the Cardinals organization. He really had an electric spring, hit 316, was 4 of 5 in stolen base attempts as an elite defensive center fielder. So this is his opening. This is his opportunity to walk through a door, and he is essentially going to be the everyday center fielder. And then once Carlson and Edman gets healthy, the Cardinals will have some decisions to make. But Victor Scott will start in center field in his major league debut on Thursday against the Dodgers.
Not a joke, but just talking because I'm a fan. I'm not a sports insider. Could the injured list, again, if they're not injured, could the injured list and one game beat the current lineup that's opening on
there's only four people
opening day?
No.
Or five. Amy.
Like, if you, there's no Lars, there's no Paul Goldschmidt, there's no Nolan Arenado, there's no Jordan Walker,
but you
no
get
Wilson
the injured
Contreras.
List plus a couple guys that aren't on the roster.
No, Amy.
Oh my God.
Okay. Well, good. That's a good answer.
The Cardinals' best pitcher is on the injured list. That's the
one game.
It's bad.
Well, anybody can win in one game in baseball.
Well, and
that's why
you
play series.
I couldn't.
That's right, Matt. You couldn't.
Okay, fine. I couldn't. You're right. Yeah. I could be part of a lineup that could potentially win a game. I'm not going to do anything, but it's one of nine. I sit there. I take my three strikes. I walk back into the dugout. I pray to God of the ball. And I'm the DH, so I never have to do anything in the field.
So Dylan Carlson will not start the season with the Cardinals.
Yes, thank you for getting us locked back in. Well, thank you.
It's very difficult around here. He is starting the season on the IL. Victor Scott will take his place. So with these injuries, look, it could end up that, and this does happen sometimes, if it's an extended stretch with a lot of injuries, you'll have trouble, but it's possible to withstand something like this if it goes on for a couple of weeks as opposed to several months.
Yeah, I'm not, gosh, I don't want to say like I'm trashing Dylan Carlson or Tommy Edman or anything. The difference in production potentially between a Victor Scott and a Dylan Carlson or a Tommy Edman, I think, is smaller than if you were to lose some other players. So there are... Again, you'd love to see Dylan Carlson be healthy. You'd love to see Tommy Edman be healthy. They make the Cardinals better. I'm not trying to say they don't, but there are other position players that their absence would be more impactful than a Carlson and Edman.
This text message says, I get what you're saying, Amy. Stop that. What do you mean? You can't get what she... That doesn't make any sense.
Thank you to the text message. Because, see, I represent the voice of the people. You two are two in the weeds. You guys are in the baseball weeds. You talk about things like war, and you don't mean conflicts, okay? And so I am a fan. I'm a fan that puts on my Cardinal clothes. I buy a hot dog and a beer, and I go there, and I watch the game and I have fun and I miss some of the game because I'm talking to people and then I watch some of the game and I'm the person that's going, well, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Look at the injured list. That's a pretty good lineup.
Amy, how many beers have you drank at a ballpark in your life?
Half of one.
No, multiple. In fact, one time there was a rain delay and we had Champions Club's tickets.
Oh, so what did you do?
Five. But they were the cups.
Wait, five beers?
You had five beers in one sitting?
Were you knocked out for 2 weeks?
No, because it was it was like a game and a rain delay. So it was over the course of like 4 hours. But they weren't cans. What do you think a can is? A half a cup? I mean, a cup is a half a can?
No, it's like,
I mean, I'm a big dude, and if I drank five beers, I would really, really, really be feeling it.
Yeah.
Well, you're not a pro like me. Oh, gosh.
Lastly, before we let you go, you saw Shohei Ohtani's press conference yesterday. It was pretty brief. Any thoughts, any new thoughts as a result of that press conference?
I mean, he actually said a little bit more than I was expecting him to say, just that he really outlined the story that they're going with. And it could be true. It might not be true. I don't know. But good for him for at least saying more than just like legalese speak.
Well, okay. So Cardinals baseball on Thursday. What do you have planned for the day?
We got Sports Open Line tonight. We got a bunch of folks that are going to be coming on. New Cardinals analyst Mark Sweeney is going to be on. I've got the whole list. I've been putting things, Matt Pajeski and I've been putting things together between yesterday. And it's a lot of stuff. They're just listening tonight.
Just a lot of stuff. So Sports Open Line tonight and tomorrow, right?
Yep.
And then actual real baseball that matters on Thursday.
Yeah. What, 3 o'clock first pitch? So we're on the air right around 2 o'clock on Thursday.
All right, Bubba.
Crazy.
We appreciate your information. Yeah.
Bubba?
Yeah. You're Bubba. You didn't like it?
He calls a lot of people
Bubba. I call a lot of people Bubba.
Okay. All right, big dog.
See you, pal.
See you.
All right. That's our guy. Right. Sports fella Matt Pauly with the news. Dylan Carlson starts the season on the injured list. Victor Scott will take his place. They say weeks, not months.
He's got
the sprained shoulder.
Yeah. What do you think of the way that Matt Pauly said that's the story they're going with when it came to Shohei
Ohtani?
There was some stank on that.
There really was. He does a lot of stank. He does a lot of... I don't know, man. I just wish he was more optimistic.
All kidding aside.
Yeah.
Didn't we talk to Mike Claiborne last Friday and he said, this story is going to keep going.
Maybe, the Ohtani story?
Yeah.
It's not going away anytime soon. By the way, our Field of 64-40 tournament, we didn't have a chance to get into any of that today because of the bridge accident. We had press conferences. Mm-hmm. There's one coming up at 1:30. So we're going to extend voting for another day. So KMOX.com, find the Field of 64-40 tournament, vote for the second round matchups. Do it now, KMOX.com. That's Amy Marks Kors. I'm Chris Ranji. Everything you missed is on the Audacy app, AUDACY. Back tomorrow, 10 o'clock on KMOX.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle, unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now, you